on this hump day. As I was saying before we started, hump day is not something what a married man usually have.
No. Wednesday is masturbation day for married
men. Wednesday's hump day in Knocker's household. Back here again live in the Sportscast Studios, brought to you by Juicy Whip, juicywhip.com. Guys built this for us, made this all possible, so make sure you guys support them. Number one hard shot, the vendors in the U.S.
Sure.
Back here, though, with Renee and the ones and twos. We got Knocker right across from me. You guys can watch all the goodness live right now at Sportscast Live. That's with a V. Or go to sportscastlife.com, guys. Check it all out.
That's with an F.
Become a VIP today. A lot of stuff going on, Knocker, today. We got MLB opening day.
Yes. It's full figure, full swing already.
NBA, NHL playoffs right around the corner.
Yeah.
We got NFL news as well. And we got a special, a little bit, you know, NFL, everyone wants something. NFL's game, any kind of football. We're going to bring you the best. We're bringing you a cheerleader today.
Yes, former
and not just any Texas cheerleader.
Yes. Former Houston Texans cheerleader Caitlin will be calling in at 7:15. So
she was ranked, what, Knocker? Wasn't she ranked like in the top?
Oh, I'm pissed off.
Oh, wait, wow. Why are you mad? She's coming on our show.
I understand that, but NFL humor ran a thing. It's on the internet. You know, you can find all kinds of crap on the internet. It's a wonderful thing.
Oh, really? You just found that out?
People should try that. But NFL humor ranked the 23 hottest NFL cheerleaders.
Yes.
And they ranked her like 20. Like, are you kidding me?
I put her in top 10.
Are you kidding? Top 2.
Right, top 10? Yeah,
gotta be. Are you kidding?
Seriously.
Unbelievable. But, yeah, she'll be calling in at 7:15. She's got aspirations and what have you. This is her first appearance since leaving the cheerleading squad of the Houston Texans.
So it's her first radio appearance she's going to have, and we're going to be the first one?
Absolutely.
That's fantastic.
Isn't it great?
That's awesome. Yeah, so sure. You know when she puts on her resume?
What?
She's going to go ahead and put, I was on the Sportscast.
Yeah. Started my
when the suits go and they look up, what's the Sportscast? They're like, ma'am, you probably shouldn't have put that on your resume. It doesn't look very good. I know those guys.
But
jackasses.
You stepped up your game since then, right?
Yeah, seriously. All right, guys. Awesome. We got also Wild World of Sports. Got the Masters.
Yes.
Everyone's favorite. That's golf right around the corner. Tigers looking okay. Out there giving hugs today. Played a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. That was good article by Bill Plaschke today.
I like him as a writer. I do.
It was he can get too corny sometimes, and
well,
he's kind of wishy washy.
Everybody can,
sometimes.
But I do like most of his.
But
stuff.
He made a good point today, and we'll get into that when we start talking about the Masters, about Tiger Woods. It was a good column.
Yeah. So, do you see anything in Tiger's future? Like,
wow, winning.
He came in 2,500 to 1 in Vegas. Yeah, I mean, no respect for.
Really?
Yeah, you could put $100 and you win $2,500 right
now.
I
would have dropped a hundy just because.
That's via your son.
You know? Yeah, I really don't think. He's been through enough embarrassment the last two tournaments that he tried to play in.
Yeah.
The sculled chip shots where he looked like me, you know, chipping from the grass.
He's bad, but I mean, what, 4 months off now, little healthy.
Looking horrible.
He's got the good vibe.
I really don't think he would go out there to embarrass himself at the Masters. He might do it in Dubai or someplace where they're going to pay him $250,000 just to show up.
Yeah.
He might go out there and play shitty there. I just don't think with his ego and his pride that he would step onto the hallowed grounds of Augusta National.
Without giving it a...
Without being at least where he feels in his mind he's competitive to make a run at the championship. You know, he's not going to go out there to play for 40th, not at the Masters.
No, I agree with
you. So I look for him to win. I think that's a pretty good bet.
Not a bad bet at all. So we'll talk about that a little later in Wild World of Sports. Also coming up, we got some NFL news. We'll talk about this, good or bad. We're going to have our first female referee coming into the season next year, Knocker. So want to talk about that, whether it's good or bad, whether the players are going to respect it, how things are going to go. So we'll get your thoughts. You would play that. You can't get the star of the show right, but you got boobies. God.
Priorities.
You got priority there.
Hey, I'm known for the boobies.
So, well, if you guys got comments on that, let us know. Got a couple moves, too, as well in the NFL. And we're going to go and judge on Gronky got the top 6 best, like, new dances. Like, these people haven't done this before as far as NFL goes. Gronky did it on Sports Nation the other day. I got the videos. We're going to go through and judge and see what's the best dance of the year so far in the NFL, okay?
All right.
Got NASCAR news. Coming up, do we have a race this week? I didn't know we didn't have a race last week. Do we have one this week?
We're racing.
We want to give a hint where we're racing this week.
And breaking news.
Oh, we got break. Do you want to break it now? Or want to wait for NASCAR news?
Yeah.
What? Bush?
They'll be turning left this week.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Don't!
You know.
Oh!
Every car out there will be turning left. Breaking NASCAR news.
Thank you for that. It's good. It was good. Just let it resonate a little bit. It was good.
Let it settle.
Let it settle in.
You know.
We're going to have a... it's going to be more like baseball in a Mexican minutes today. We're going to get a lot of baseball talking.
Mas minutos.
Yeah, so get ready. Renee's big segment. He was getting chubs over there with all his tweets that came in last week with the baseball questions.
Yeah, right.
Tweet us at sportscast_THN. Knocker, as always, will be on the Twitter feed. And guys, the phone lines are open once again. 818-435-8423. Again, 818-435-8423. Best way to get a hold of us. And yeah, a lot of stuff going on baseball. We'll get to our division winner predictions. We'll go over that. Mm-hmm. Also, we got a Cubs fans are now peeing in cups, so we'll talk about that. They got to get porta potties out there at out there in Chicago.
Class,
yeah. And we're going to go over how much beer costs in each stadium. Are you getting ripped off? Who's got the highest? Who's got the cheapest?
Yeah, you're getting ripped off.
Yeah, so
beer.
There it is. NBA, we're going to talk a little bit. Had a stabbing. Some sad news this morning. If you saw the story at sportscastlife.com, guys, had some big stories out there today. Chris Copeland of the Pacers was stabbed late last night, and his wife was slashed outside of a New York club.
What?
So, yeah, we'll bring you the details on that. And also, is Golden State for real? Can you trust Golden State going to the playoffs? Now, I know they can shoot. They've got Steph Curry. They've got Thompson. They've got all the right pieces right now. They've got Kerr leading the way. But they haven't proved. I still am skeptical for reason. But am I wrong for thinking that?
Not at all. Not until they win a big series.
Okay, we'll talk about that and more. So you see, if you can watch on camera here, Johnny Ice has got his front-running Duke jersey on over here in the corner. Can you tell us why you have that, sir? Did you go to Duke or attend any of their?
I opened a can of Mountain Dew, and it had a number on it, and I typed it into the computer, and they sent me a free Duke jersey.
Attaboy.
Johnny. Ice!
Oh my God!
You are one pathetic loser.
So he's sporting his well-earned
Duke jersey.
Hey, why not, man?
Even though the guy,
right?
Yeah, even though
there was a number, I typed it in, and they were like, "You won a jersey."
There Duke, you go,
I was
man.
Like, "All right." That was back in like 2005.
I wonder, do you know who 22 on Duke is?
I think it was Grant Hill back in the day.
He probably did the commercials 22? For Mountain Dew. So
this was. Yeah, back in the day.
I think so. I think that would be Grant Hill's number, if I'm not mistaken.
All right. I like it.
Not bad.
We're going to talk about how college basketball is completely rigged, and everybody, it's like CBS. It gets on the phone during these timeouts, these replays, like, hey, guys, we really need Kentucky. We really need Duke in the finals. Dude, we're going to try and swing the game. Because everybody has an HD television. Everybody saw the ball hit his fingertips. It was Wisconsin ball with a minute 50 left in a five-point game.
Why have the replay?
Come on!
We had the referee's jersey right there because he has been fired by
Thank you.
NCAA.
Oh, we took his jersey? We have
the
jersey on camera
right
now? Nice.
Hall of shame in
took
the
his
studio.
Jersey? That's fantastic. So we'll talk about the national championship game. We got a little bit of you got knocked the fuck out today. Anybody that has a selfie stick, you better stick around for this one because you're going to want to watch it because selfie sticks are gay, people. Do not use them. A shot of the week award. One of our favorite segments. If you got a shot or a shit of the week, make sure you guys tweet us at sportscast_THN. That'll be at around 7:30. So get those in by the time we get there. And we'll talk about a little bit of other stuff coming up, trending videos on the website and so forth. So
the Colonel does,
big show.
The Colonel does chime in.
Yeah, he's in like Kansas right now.
Does at Johnny Icebuck have the name Douche on the back of that jersey too?
Douchey.
We have a call, by the way.
We have a call already. All right, we have a call already. All right,
I was trying to get your attention, but you were looking at me.
I wasn't looking. I'm sorry.
All right, we got in the line as possible, Renee.
Caller, who we got in the line?
Hi, this is Veronica Harris. Hi, bud.
What's up, Coach V?
Coach V.
Hi.
How are you?
I've been waiting so long to call you. I've seen you guys, your studio. It was awesome. You guys look awesome. You guys sound funny as I don't know what. But I'm glad to be calling in to say congratulations on your new start.
Well, that is very sweet of you, Coach V. Coach V is... one of the crew at the show that they allowed me to call in on Tuesdays in the game.
Oh, nice.
On BKS1 Radio on Tuesdays 6 to
8. Yeah, the show that's trying to steal my co-host away from me. Is that what it is?
Nah, we're not trying to steal him. We just like his rest coach perspective. But hey, I'm the wrong female over there. So, yeah, but brother and I, we had a nice, I think, welcome conversation about a couple of weeks ago. But, yeah, it's been good. I like talking to him. It's really good.
It was kind of funny because we were talking about DeAndre Jordan and the Clippers, right?
Yeah.
And it was near the end of the show. And I had made a comment saying that DeAndre had the same role that like Bill Russell had with the Celtics. And then we got cut off. And it was crazy because 2 weeks went by, And the first thing that she said to me and the first thing I said to her was, she goes, "Now, Bud Knocker, I got a bone to pick with you." I go, "It's about the Bill Russell comment, right?" She goes, "Hell yeah."
Listen, I've been waiting 2 weeks to speak to you, and then you was like, "I've been waiting 2 weeks too." So it was like, "Oh, great minds think alike." But yeah, I mean, you were on my mind for those 2 weeks because I was totally dissecting everything you had to say, and I was like, "Well, maybe I need to rethink my attitude about that." Right. But no, it was a good conversation.
But we
thoroughly enjoyed it.
We just had a little conversation with myself and Josh about instant replay and the role it plays, and the big controversial call in the Duke Wisconsin game.
It's not even just in that game. It's a game before that where the guy slapped in the face. They go to replay. It's complete flagrant foul. It changes the way the game goes. People have conspiracy theories because of crap that happens like this in games. It's ridiculous. It completely sways the way of the game, and it's obvious to just the normal fan now. It's getting to the point where you can't. They're trying to make the public look stupid, and that's just not the right thing to do.
Yeah, I would totally agree with you. And if you know the guy, John Adams, he's being replaced. He's been, his contract, I think, is only for one more year, that he's being let go. And they're actually going to be hiring somebody else to be the head of officials. Because they want somebody who embraces technology a little bit more. But I can't believe that he would have the audacity to come on air. I mean, I understand transparency, but you want to come on air and say to people that we did not have the replay that everybody else saw.
What?
All the money. Yeah. Yes. You didn't hear that? You didn't hear that?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. Josh did, but I didn't.
No, I heard his thing.
He came out and said we didn't have the replay?
Yeah. They're trying to say they don't have the same views we have.
We did not see the replay. Our officials did not have the benefit of the replay that everybody else had that saw clearly that the call, wasn't right.
Well, then how about they subscribe to Fios or cable so they can get the damn replay?
Yeah, really? Yeah. Or how about, because everyone's sitting there like,
"You know who I am? I've seen you before. You're the asshole on TV."
Like, that's exactly what they think of that ref right there. It's like, dude, I've seen that. Come on. We all have HD televisions. You're not telling me that out of those 10 billion TVs lined up on the side of the court, that not one of them saw the same thing we did?
That's amazing.
Come on. It's just ridiculous.
Just look up.
I agree.
At the time, the teams are looking up. Like, you just look up. I mean, really, it's so, I think that's what makes it so egregious is that it takes so little to get it right. And I'm not saying, like, there's a really, when I say it takes so little, I'm not trying to say there's like a real quick fix to the situation, but really it does. If somebody would just do a little bit of extra work, just look up. I mean, just use the God-given sense that God gave you.
Yep, I agree. I agree with you, V. V said it like it is, So, well, V-Man, we appreciate you. Are you watching the show right now?
Yes, I was watching a little bit. I had to pull over because I'm actually driving. I'm on my way down to Disney.
Okay, well, when you turn it back on, I want you to let us know who's the better looking one here, okay?
Well, I don't know all your names, but I know Bud Knocker. I was able to figure that out. And I was like, he was pretty good.
Well, no, like I said, I'm the good looking one, like I said. So just when you watch the show, go back and say, dude, that guy with the hat on, awesome.
Oh,
just,
you want to answer back?
Yeah, I want an answer back, of course.
Oh,
I'm cute. Yeah, that's all I wanted to hear. All right, thank you. Thank you. You made my day. All right, thank you, V. We appreciate you calling the show, girl. Spread the word, and we appreciate it, man. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Coach V.
All right, thank you. All right, bye, baby.
Bye.
I had to get that out of her. She said I'm cute.
She's very knowledgeable. She really knows her stuff, and she don't mind speaking her mind.
Or she's blind. So.
I'm like, what's that? You say she's blind?
Well, screw you, man. I hope she's not driving that car then.
Screw you guys.
I had to pull over because I'm blind.
Oh, man. All right, guys. Well,
we have failed to. We have a couple, actually. Special,
we have two guests in studio right now.
Go ahead.
We have Johnny's father-in-law.
You heard me talk about him on the show before. This is my father-in-law, John.
Speaking of the mic, John, say hello.
Go ahead, say hi.
How are we doing there?
There he is. There he is.
He's almost officially a Californian.
Almost, yeah. You're moving out here, right?
Yeah.
From where?
From New York.
New York, big change?
Oh, yeah, big change.
Yeah, you already said you got here.
Sunshine,
love the weather, right?
Palm trees, yeah. Can't beat it.
Can't beat it, right?
Nope.
So we'll get to him later in the show. You're going to think of some dirt here on Johnny Icebox here. If you got any stories, anything, I'd love to hear them.
He's heard them all. He's probably been around for most of them.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Yeah.
And also, go ahead, you can introduce our next. We've got a full packed house. We've got our own studios. People's coming by.
Mr. Steve Molinari. We've had his daughter, actually, when we were at the Universal City studios.
Yeah, he's got like four blonde daughters. Think of that. If you're a mm-hmm. father, you got four blonde daughters in California. My God.
Why is my father-in-law got to be here?
Where are your daughters?
Was it Cassie or Caitlin? It was Cassie, right?
Say what's up. Talking to the mic.
You can flip the mic over. Slide on up. Steve, just talking to the mic real quick.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, Steve.
I'm just here to bring the booze.
Booze man. All right.
Speaking of booze, Daniel, please bring Steve Molinari a drink. Thank you very much.
Yeah, mix him up a drink, bud. What are you doing out there?
I'll take some more ice, too.
Yeah. Okay, Steve?
Yeah, get it.
Oh, there's cups in that.
Steve's just gonna drink the Maker's Mark to himself.
All right, Steve. Oh wow. Steve just needs a cup of ice, and Johnny needs gross. A refill of ice.
It's gonna be one
ice.
Of those shows, Renee. You better keep up today.
So Daniel, bring it.
He asked me if he could eat chocolate before the show. You know that? You know I gave him the special chocolate before the show. He asked if he could eat it, and I said, "No, you're not allowed to touch that before the show.
No,
it's not allowed.
No, we've got a small dog on the premises. You are not allowed to get high today."
Did you guys ever watch the Tom Green show back in the day?
Did watch Tom Green?
That guy that used to just sit in the background and laugh like.
Yeah, totally. I do remember.
That's you.
Go ahead. Take the Lakers glass.
Yeah, take him. Take one up.
Oh, you've never been here before, have you?
No, he has not. Tell Dan to get his ass one. Well, we're
gonna
go ahead. You can leave.
I'm going to take a 30-second break.
Yeah, we don't need you to do anything on this show anyway. So, all right, guys. So, again, if you want to call the show, 818-435-8423 or tweet us at sportscast_THN. Again, coming up at about after the first break, we're going to have Houston Texans cheerleader on. So, do not miss that. And get your shot and shit of the week award in now. So, all right, guys. First of all, we're going to get everyone's favorite. It's the NFL. It's what's most popular. Let's hit it, Renee. You ready?
Yep. Wow.
Well, it's never a bad time to talk football. NFL. I mean, it's already, what, April?
Love it.
I mean, it's already, think
you
about
can
it.
Smell
it's
it.
Coming.
You can smell
you got
it,
that
man.
little hint of it.
Yeah.
A little hit of the NFL. So we got a couple moves going on. Getting some Gronky moves as well. And a couple stories. So again, you guys want to chime in, call or tweet the show?
Yeah, see?
All right.
Our waiter.
Here we go. Yeah, what are you doing out there, Giants fans? You come on the show two prior weeks. You're like, you got to do something.
There's a 30-second delay
as he's watching outside. Got a whole viewing party today. It's fantastic.
That's what I'm talking about. We tried to get Johnny's wife to be the waitress.
She's watching. MacGyver's here. MacGyver the dog is back yeah. over. So, all right. Throw me a little something here in the back if you got, Renee. As we go over here first now, LaRon Landry, if you guys remember him, played for the Colts. Redskins.
Oh, God. I saw this picture. Redskins. Dude, there's something seriously wrong.
Okay. Now, this cat got suspended for using PEDs. For basically being an idiot and taking pictures like the one you'll see, Renee. If you got the picture of LaRon Landry's arms working out, big buff dude. Look at these arms now. If you guys aren't watching live, sportscastlife.com or sportscast live on Ustream, check these out. You guys can watch the screen over here, guys.
That's just
look
out.
These are cartoonishly big arms. And you ask, what? And you're like, how did this guy not get suspended? It's the guy on the right there, or on the left if you're looking at the screen. And huge, huge arms. I mean, these are like Popeye arms.
That must be 60-inch biceps. I mean, that's just,
I'm afraid they're going to explode on me.
Seriously. And just spew goo everywhere.
Yeah.
That's not right.
Like, he can't come back to the NFL, right? I don't think there's any way he could come back to the NFL looking like that.
No.
You just crush a man's skull. It's like the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah.
You got a phone call again?
Yeah.
God, your phone's just going crazy.
Bring it.
Guys, I'd like to talk on this show.
Okay, at least two people are watching. Well, three now.
What?
Daniel and Coach B.
Yeah.
And now we got another call, so... Awesome.
We might have more.
We're stepping up.
Stepping up in the world. That's 40,000 downloads. Give me the phone calls. Who we got on the line?
Hey, this is Coach P.
Coach P? Who's Coach P? It's
Paris?
I'm the limo driver of this fantastic show.
What is up, Paris? How you feeling, man? Let me explain. Paris, last week, I was tweeting him before the show, and... Somebody ran a red light and crashed his limo, and he was on the way to the hospital, but he was still tweeting the show, man. I got a broken arm and concussion, but I'm still watching, man.
Nice.
But how are you, Paris? Are you okay?
I'm a little busted. I got a broken arm, a couple of bruised ribs, busted knee.
Yeah, bro.
Hematoma to the left side of the head, but there's no bleeding, so
God, you know, what happened to him?
I was able to tune in last week and get a part of it and listen. That's what I call dedication. Put me in, coach.
That's
Jesus,
what I'm talking about.
What was he on, UFC 185 over the weekend? What the hell happened to him? Ronda Rousey beat your ass?
He didn't miss a fair, that's what I'm talking about.
Jesus Christ.
But, if you remember when your mother and I went to L.A. to see George Strait last year, you kids bought us the tickets to go see George Strait.
George Strait?
Guilty! Fuck you.
Seriously, yeah, you know what? It was actually about a year ago, almost to the date, and I believe your son had just had a little fender bender at the time.
Oh, that's when Daniel totaled his car, isn't it? That's right.
Yeah.
That's what Daniel totaled his
car.
But yeah, Paris was our limo driver, wonderful man, and turns out he's a big football fan. He coaches. And,
yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, your Marquise Lee is your nephew or something like that, and Vontaze Perfect.
And Vontaze Perfect. Absolutely right.
Nice. I got some players. I like that.
Awesome.
Got some stories there, I'm sure.
So what do you think about this? I'm sure you watched. I know all your friends are basketball fans and what have you. What do you think of this replay fiasco?
You know, it gets a little crazy. I kind of tied. I'm kind of in the middle on that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's you know, I like the replay. You know, with so much on the line and at stake, let's get it right.
Okay. The problem is they didn't get it right. And how do they not have the proper angle?
Get it right. And it's hard not to get it right when the whole world sees it and you don't. So, real quick, we're talking football here. And since, you know, you got a couple of your close buddies here that play in the football, Sarah Thomas going to be the first full-time female referee in the NFL coming up this season, good or bad? And what do you think how the players are going to react to this?
Well, I better not say that.
No, say it.
It's okay. It's okay.
This is the one show you can say it.
We're used to getting hate mail. Just bring it.
You know, there's a couple of NBA female referees that are kind of hot. So I don't know. I don't have a problem with it. You know what? Again, for the integrity of the game, just, you know, keep it honest. Let's get it right. You know, whether male, female, undecided, or whatever. For the integrity of the game, man, just go ahead and just do your job. I don't have a problem with women referees.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with that.
All right, cool.
Should be the first, huh? Ever?
Yes.
Yeah, first ever in the NFL.
In the NFL. Now, what do you think of the injury factor? Because seriously, it's one thing to be a 190-pound Ed Hockley with the guns. You know, getting.
I don't think they're putting the chick in the middle of the field where the linebackers are. I think she's probably going to be a side judge.
But still,
you know what I mean.
That would be what, the umpires area. Yeah, we probably because of size. Yeah, that could be an issue. Maybe we have to, you know, side judge a few of them. You know, because if she's going to be playing umpire, man, she's sitting right beyond the linebackers. Exactly, she's right there.
Yeah, I'm
where,
not sure. I'm
all,
not sure
all
that's
going to
happen.
Crazy
but
stuff going
exactly.
On.
So,
yeah, but still, I mean, the threat is there. She's, yeah. You know, unless she's a Hulk, I haven't seen her. I mean, unless she's Olga from the Ukraine.
Olga, funny.
You know,
she looks like that girl from Dodgeball. You know, with the fucked up teeth, dude. She's fucking. Do I get a ding on that? Can I ding myself on that?
All right. Yourself, yeah.
Thank you.
Dodgeball girl.
All right. Well, Coach P, man, we appreciate the call. And, man, we wish you well, man. Get better with all those broken bones, buddy.
Hey, I'm coming back better and stronger, man. We're going to get rid of Suburban. I'm going to come back with this 2015 Escalade on you, baby.
Yeah, there we go.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm sorry, Josh. One more quick question. I know you guys and your buddies are big NBA fans. The Golden State Warriors, Josh was asking a little earlier in the show, are they for real? Do you have doubts? I mean, do we wait till they win a big series? What do you think? Are they getting too much run right now?
I've had Golden State picked for the last 3 years, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
I think the previous 2 years, injuries killed their run.
Yeah.
But with them being healthy this year, I was just talking to a buddy yesterday. I said, hey, these guys missed the Bulls record thus far. I know there's still, 4 or 5 games left, but they missed the best record by about 4 games. They had 14 losses, and, of course, that made them lose that night, so now they've got 15. They were 5 off what Michael Jordan did with the Bulls, man. They went, 72-10?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A much better league.
So, I mean, you got to look at them as a contender. I would definitely see Golden State and probably San Antonio, who doesn't turn it on until playoff time. Look what they're doing
now.
Right now. Just being
exactly.
Under the radar for the middle part of the season. Now Green's going crazy and Leonard's going crazy. It's just everything's falling into place at the right place at the right time for them, which that's how Pop runs that team. Let's cruise control, get to the party, and then we'll dance. Again, you're going to have San Antonio in there as, maybe a 5th seed?
Mm-hmm.
They're turning on just a little later than usual. But yeah, San Antonio, I mean, until they lose, I got to roll with them because they're just, no one ever gives them credits every year. Everyone counts out San Antonio like this is the year, and every year they prove everyone wrong.
Yeah, and they're doing that. They don't do it fancy. They just get it done.
Yep.
You look at what they did to my Heat, man. They just crushed us just by playing fundamental YMCA park ball. Pass, move the ball to the open man. Let's get some good high percentage shots.
Not that hard, huh?
On the other hand, you got to look at Golden State. Their second five could actually start on most teams.
That's true.
In the East.
Yep.
They'd probably be the number three qualifier in the East.
Right now. Oh, man, are you kidding me? I mean, look what comes off the bench. You got Iguodala coming off the bench for these guys.
Yeah.
And Curry right now, who am I drive for? What's up, Steph? He's firing on all cylinders right now. Clay's firing on all cylinders right now.
Yeah, that's good.
And I just had both those guys a couple of weeks ago, man, and they're pretty confident. I talked to them. I said, guys, is this it? Is this the year? He goes, man, we let you down 3 years in a row, but we feel good about this year, you know?
All right, hey, Paris, pimp out your company, man. Pimp out your company for people who need limo rides. Where can they get the best quality service?
Oh, man, Executive Sedan Service over in Inglewood, California, next to LAX, serving all major airports, man.
All right, that's next time we go, about. Next time we get to a game out there and we calling you up, you're going to hook it up, all right?
Oh, most definitely, man. I got you guys covered. VIP five-star service all the way for nothing but the best for the best sportscast show.
All right. Oh,
you got a Twitter? I'm about to follow you. It's Johnny Ice, by the way.
Do you have a Twitter, Paris?
Do you guys have a Twitter?
Good talking to you guys. Now, you know what? I got to do my Twitter, man. My guy's been getting on me about
it. Get on that, dude.
I'll be your first follow, man.
Johnny, be your first follow.
All right, well,
bro.
Paris, we're going to hit you up, man. When we ever need a little buddy, for sure, we'll hook it up out there.
Hey, most deaf. I'm going to be listening in for the rest of the remainder of the show.
Buddy.
Man, it feels good to
thank you for listening.
Be back talking to you guys again. I'm sorry my heavy schedule has prevented me from calling in as much as I want to, but I'll definitely be tuning in over the next couple of days and interacting. I love you guys, man. I miss you guys a lot.
No
all
worries,
my brother.
Thank
you, care,
Paris.
Get better,
part of the
man.
Family, man. Thank you very much. All right, man.
Most deaf. Say hello to the fam.
All right.
Man, I saw
I'm glad I got a limo hookup now whenever I want. It's fantastic.
Oh, most definitely.
Yeah.
Don't make me text you pictures. I think I text you pictures already. Don't make me put the Phantom out there.
All right. Wow. Man, Jesus, man.
Do not have me come down there and pick you guys up in the Phantom and drop you off at the Staples Center.
That's fantastic.
Yeah,
check it out. That's awesome. Woo! All right. It's fantastic. Paris, thanks once again, buddy.
All right, baby. I'll talk to you guys.
All right, bud.
We got the club hookups in Vegas now. We got the limo hookups now.
Yeah. So. Straight balling.
Balling, balling. All right, guys. We're going to get to break when we get back. We're going to have a special guest on the line, Houston Texans cheerleader. Going to be with us. Stick around for that. Also, we're going to talk just a little bit more. Female referee, good or bad in the NFL? Give us your thoughts. We're going to go around the table here, get everyone's opinions. Also on the way, baseball opening day. We've got our predictions, a lot more news. Wildwood of Sports. Much more shot of the week.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to take a shit on someone, let us know. Sportscast_THN. Wow. We'll be back after this.
stars. I wanna die in your arms. Oh, oh, oh. 'Cause you get lighter the more it gets dark. I'm gonna give you my heart. Oh.
Big segment coming up. We got a special Houston, Texas cheerleader going to be calling the show in just a few minutes. Also coming up, Wobble to Sports. You got knocked the fuck out as well.
Nice.
And, nice. Yeah, we got Jack Nicklaus getting a hole-in-one earlier, so we're going to talk about that later on in the show.
Well, way
so,
to pimp it.
Yeah. What?
That was my shot of the week, but we'll still go for that. We'll still go with that.
Shot? That was your shot of the week?
Well, fuck yeah. 75-year-old man
gets
a hole-in-one.
Way to do your research.
Get
the top story of the day and make it my shot of the week. Wow, way to put some thought into the fucking segment. Good job. Christ.
Fuck you.
Yeah, seriously.
She's a gay wad.
Yeah, gay wad. Exactly. That's what they called you. All right, guys. A couple of news, just news and notes.
Daniel.
News and notes.
Your dad needs a drink.
Coming up in the show, we got Wes Welker could be possibly signing with the Miami Dolphins knocker. So he's going to be, that's actually, I think, the team that drafted him.
Is that right?
The Dolphins. So Welker, despite all the concussions, injury problems.
Is he a free agent?
Yeah, he can go ahead and sign wherever he'd like.
Okay, now what do you do with him? Do you sign him?
I give him one-year contracts. Right now with NFL guys, like I think what Cowboys did with Dez Bryant with the off-the-field issues, why not franchise tag these goons? Or not these goons, but these guys who are having problems with the off-the-field. You don't have to worry about long contracts, sign them to a long-year deal. They get good amount of money, and there's really no risk involved. So I think with Welker, yeah, I wouldn't mind paying the guy $5 million for a year. Why not?
God,
NFL just, franchise. I got $5 million to spend on a guy that could probably.
It's just hard for a man my age, right, to think of $5 million is just nothing. That's just a basic.
Yeah, that's
low,
nothing for a receiver.
Low
right
salary
now.
In the NFL, $5 million. That,
I mean, even if he plays 12 games, if Welker gives me 12 games at healthy, I'll take him for $5 million.
No, I think he's done.
Okay, well, we got also that
what
could
do you
be
think,
going
John?
On. John, what do you think?
I'm in my own zone here.
Yeah, he's in his zone. Don't go to him if he's not in his zone.
Checking out Sarah, checking out Sarah Thomas.
Oh, though the referee, right? Yeah.
Line judge.
Official line judge. Okay, official line judge. So again, Stephen Ridley going to be signing possibly with the Jets as well. So those are going to be your two off the offseason.
Sorry, I don't risk
NFL
the money
news
on Wes Welker. He's just too
back
hurt
to Sarah Thompson though. This girl now she's going to be a first female line judge. Great. So she's allowed to call penalties. Is that right? Can she call penalties as a line judge? Can anyone call penalties?
I think anyone on the field can call a penalty.
So she can be pass interference. Okay. So the first time that a play goes wrong or a call goes wrong against the team, you know she's going to get Twitter hate. She's going to get social
sure
media.
She is.
She's going to get everything out there. She's going to get guys talking trash to her. Do you think at some point it's going to become too much for her?
No. Not if she's made it this far. I'm sure she's gotten all the crap that she's going to get on every level that she's been at.
Do you think she's going to have a lower tolerance, though? Because, male referees are used to them. They know how males act, especially in the heat of the moment during the game. Maybe drop an F-bomb here. Maybe, fuck that ref. You missed that call. Does the woman tee the guy up for that? Do they give him an unsportsmanlike penalty for that? Because she's a girl and she takes it more offensively?
I think that's an interesting question because she could play it both ways.
That's what I'm saying. Right?
And we're not questioning her sexuality.
Right.
But she could play it both ways. She could be, that tough. I got to be tough and show them that I'm the boss and, the first
can't let
guy,
him walk all over me. I got
to
make,
the
yeah.
The first guy that does shit to me, I'm throwing him out of the game because I'm going to show him who's boss. Or she could be a little more lenient. To the other end saying, I got to be part of the game. I got to, build my reputation with them and not, it's just kind of, I'm okay that, you can say shit and I'm not going to overreact. And blah, blah,
right.
Blah. I think it's a very fine line for her to walk. Now, me personally, if it was me.
Yeah.
First guy that came up to me and said, you blew that fucking call. Yeah, and said, you know what?
Okay.
You can take a shower and talk about me all you want. You're gone.
Okay, so I'll go to you. If they call her a bitch, does that draw the line for a personal foul?
What do you think?
I think on the field anything's fair play.
I think only the C word.
Yeah, maybe the C word.
Yep. What do you think, Steve?
That's what
my
girls would say.
He's got four
got
of, them.
Of them.
He's got four. Yeah, especially the wife.
There's definitely some male line judges that are bitches.
Yeah, that's true. Not lately. Okay, that they've heard. Then you've heard. Yeah, I'm sure you have.
Damn. I think the C
word.
But
Steve's right,
one.
And so is John Wright saying that C word is something that hits a woman like no
That's
other
like
word.
The N word. Yeah. The C
like,
word.
Bitch. Yeah, they're gonna get pissed, but that gets flown around.
Sure.
But you dropped that C bomb. Yeah,
that's a whole different.
You're in the doghouse for year for that one.
In 33 years, I've never used it.
Yeah. There you go.
He's a smart man.
So, John, so you don't think if I drop, you missed that call, you bitch, like, I'm not going to get a personal foul for that?
I say no. If she does, I think she's crossing a line because it doesn't exist today because of her integrating into the NFL sport. I don't think they should.
I think that she's got to know that to be able to referee
in
the league.
Some of the male refs have heard that.
No,
be
I know
what, with
but,
you.
But a male's not going to take that offensive, though, like a woman is. That's my whole point, though.
Well, I mean, the male referees have
the
heard.
Female's going to take
asshole,
everything
dickhead,
more personal than a male is going to because she is a female. And
I don't think so. But just someone's going to hear it. I mean, there's mics everywhere.
She misses her first call. Ooh, female referee can't be in the NFL. Look it, they're not as good. I mean, there's so many storylines that are going to go along with this.
I don't think so. Not in this day and age. There's not going to be
I just want to say, can we get a chest cam going with her? Like a chest cam? Can we get a chest cam? I'm just saying, there's a lot of stuff they do now. Let's get a chest cam.
There's
not much chest on there. Ed Hockley's got more chest than she's got.
Unless they're tied down, I don't know. Maybe the twins.
Yeah, the sports bras.
I don't really think it's a problem. Again, if they use the C word in a confrontational conversation or even muttering under their breath, then that's it. I think that's the only word that. The players cannot use.
So you don't think it's going to have any effect at all in the NFL? You think it's going to go fly?
No.
It might be a story first couple weeks.
They'll test
it. It's
just
no different than the N-word. They can't even use it in the locker room.
Exactly.
That's true.
Exactly. It's just like Danica Racing. They're still testing her. But
she's copping into a man's world, and if she's got to have the thick skin to be able to get through it. So.
Absolutely.
Okay,
I don't see it as a problem. If she knows her shit, she knows her shit. Because you got to admit, there's a whole lot of men referees that are out there that fuck up calls, and you wonder, what were you looking at? What were you seeing? So if she knows her shit, she knows her shit. Let her ref. What the hell? Who cares, man?
Agree.
All right. Well, before we get our phone caller, who should be on in just a couple minutes here, we got some Gronky dances. Now, these are the top five voted dances, okay, in the NFL this year, new dances that players came up with. And I don't understand some of these things that the players do. Like, it's not even a dance. It's like, are you twerking? Are you doing some kind of, stretching?
Everybody's got to be original. I mean, it's pretty hard to find original stuff these days.
Okay, the first one. Get the Antonio Bryant dance up there. This is my favorite because this is it right in your wheelhouse right here. Have you seen your boy Antonio Brown do this before? Throw up the video here. Yeah, Antonio Brown.
Times.
It's called the Antonio Brown dance. Yeah. All right. You have it there. It's called Antonio. There it is.
There it is.
Play this video. Now, what do you call that? Like, I don't. Is that like the half sprinkler?
What is that?
It's Gronk imitating the dance that Antonio Brown's
that
doing.
That looks like fucking Fred Flintstone like, bowling.
I don't know. Yeah, it's like... Like, I don't know what that's supposed to be.
Those of us over 40 know that joke.
Twinkle toes.
There's a lot of bunch of guys out there laughing at over 40.
That's the dance right there?
That's it.
All right. I like that.
That's his bowling approach.
Exactly, man.
He's got the one hand with
it. Don't look at an old Flintstone. That's fucking Fred Flintstone.
Bowling approach. I like that. These could all be bowling approaches, if you think about it. You know, I've seen bowling.
Barney Rubble had his own approach. Yeah. I mean, that's
all right, we got the next one up here is called the Michael Bennett Rick Rude Dance. All right, if you could throw that, the Rick Rude Dance. Check it out here if you guys are watching us live. This is the Rick Rude here. This is the little hip shake here.
Yeah, the Rude Awakening.
Yeah, the Rude Awakening, the little hip thrust, you know, right there. I could see a bowler pulling that off. All these he's like, all right, I'm going to stretch, getting ready for the strike. These are all bowling moves. Now just think about it, people. Next one up here.
I've actually done that one.
That's fantastic. Oh, man. Next one up is called, it's from Von Miller, called the Rooster Dance. You got the Rooster Dance there for me, Renee? Again, you guys can watch us live at Sportscast Live on Ustream. That's called the Rooster Dance. What do you call that? Like, what do you call it?
It's called taking a shit while walking.
Yeah, it's like, you're taking a poop while you're walking. I don't understand. That's after you've had too many chili fries and you got a bowl, and you're like, fuck, I got to get up to the ring.
I got to throw this ball, man, I got to get to the head.
Man, those nachos, I shouldn't have got the jalapenos. Damn it.
That's the butt squeeze, man.
So that's the rooster dance there for you.
Yeah.
This last two we got here is from John Brown in the NFL called the Spaz Dance for good reason. This is just, I guess, you just do it. Like, I don't know what that is. Like, what is that?
Yeah.
It's like Tybo. Is that like that's Tybo boxing?
That's a white dude 2 beers into the night, man.
That's Frank Kaminsky, right?
That's a white dude 2 beers in thinking he's just knocking it out of the park, bro.
That's so true.
Am I right?
That is so true. That's the guy in the club. That just like, oh, man. But he doesn't care, and you got to give him.
Oh,
you know,
no. He thinks he's hitting a home run, man. Look at me. Woo!
This last 20 years called the Anthony Costanzo. I don't know what you call these dances, really. I don't know where these players come up with it. It's called the Anthony Costanzo. It's I believe it's the Mortal Kombat one you got there from a Mortal Kombat movie. Now, look at this one. This is actually out of a video game, like a finishing move of a video game here. Like, what do you call this? Like, that's right. That's done before bowling. I can see, John. I can see you pulling that one off. The hammies are a little tight. You're like, I got to get it out, you know, get the core going.
It was after the ninth strike.
When you're going for the turkey? Is that when you're going for the turkey?
That's not talking.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's awesome.
Oh, my God. I have one comment.
Yes, okay. You go ahead. Get on the mic. Pull it up. Step up to the mic here.
Just one comment.
Just a piece. Speak into it.
Yeah, but you got to talk right. No.
Have these
there
guys.
You go.
Right.
Yeah, go ahead. Talk it out.
Share that one right there.
Have these guys ever made a touchdown before?
No, I don't think. Antonio Brown has. That's
well,
the
Antonio,
only one.
That's about the only
and
one.
And you act like you've done it before.
Yeah. And the funny thing is, Steve, like you said, half these guys are like getting a tackle, and they're like, you know, dancing because I made a tackle. It's like you make 100
sacks
of them a season.
You got 2 sacks all year long and you're dancing.
And we saw earlier, it's a couple guys actually tore their Achilles doing their dance moves earlier
that's
this year.
Karma at its best.
Well, we got a phone call. We got a phone call right now. All right. Hope it's our special guest. All right, you're online with the Sportscast. Who do we have on the line?
This is Caitlin.
All right.
How we doing, Caitlin? How you doing?
We all sounded
I'm
real creepy
good,
right
I
there.
I know, right?
Ooh, Caitlin.
Really? Well, thanks for calling in, Caitlin. We've been crossing paths back and forth for a while, and it's really great to have you on. I'm sure it's kind of bittersweet right now, especially with the tryouts going on for the Texas Cheerleader. I think the finals were like yesterday, were they not?
Yeah, they announced yesterday. It's definitely bittersweet. It's great to see all my friends make the team back, but a little part of me wishes I was out there with them, you know?
Well, absolutely. Absolutely. It's a sisterhood. It's, you know, I've been kind of, we had a couple ladies from the Titans cheerleaders call in.
Yeah, they love you, Budnacker.
The last years. And it's kind of like, it's, you know, it's not just, okay, we're there for, you know, the football season and then we go our own way. This is like a 24/7, 365 gig, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a lot more time consuming than it appears, especially with the Houston Texans. We, like, got requested for, like, personal appearances and stuff all the time. And we had, like, a minimum amount of appearances we had to do. We had to do 40 a year.
Wow.
So we practiced 3 times a week from 7 o'clock sometimes to, like, midnight. And then we had games every other weekend or so. And then we also had appearances during the week.
Now, wow. I got a question for you, Caitlin. Now, as you know, the tryouts are going on right now. And with all the reality shows out there and all this stuff, there's a lot of drama. Now, I want to know the inside scoop. I want to know the inside scoop here. You guys all look nice on camera, all the pretty pictures, all the selfie pictures. I know there's some hate, woman hate going on in that group there. Is there, now you don't have to get into detail too much, but really, is there some real true competition between girls where it sometimes gets ugly?
Well, during the season, absolutely not. Like, I can't stress how much of a family it is to be on the Texans cheer team. We all really did love each other. Now, during tryouts, everybody's super nice, but you tell that everybody's super, like, hesitant or, like, a little reserved because it's like, they're like, well, I'm competing against you, you know, so they're not going to immediately just, like, jump out and be your friend. Everyone's
like
super nice to you, but you can kind of feel a little animosity when you're there because it's like, everyone's kind of on edge. Like, even being a, like, returning cheerleader, it's like, your spot is not secure, so you're always on edge.
Yeah, so it's more like a episode of Survivor, right? Everyone gets their own clicks. Like, I'll be with you, man. Well, let's vote her off. We'll get her out of the group, and then we'll stick together. It's all a bunch of mind games, right, back and forth.
Let's mess her makeup
up. Yeah, something
up.
Like that.
Exactly.
Know, like put something in her hairspray or something like that. But, I mean, it's kind of like a beauty pageant where everybody's like Miss Congeniality on the surface, but, you know, it's like, well, I'm not sure I want her on the squad. Yeah. So, you know.
But once they come together, it's all good and family. So that's the good part.
So I was Look, well, let's go to this one first, and I'm sure you're tired of hearing of it, but you know, our fans, this is your first time. This is actually your first radio appearance since you stepped down as a cheerleader, right?
Yeah, I technically just stepped down as cheerleader like yesterday.
We're honored. We are honored.
Absolutely, we are honored.
Well, thank you. I'm honored special. To be on.
Well, thank you. now you did something last year, I'm sure you're tired of hearing about it, but we have to bring it up, and that's just one of the things that happens. And we actually have a picture.
Way to piss off the guest right away, Doctor. Good job.
And we actually have a picture of it. But this is one of the reasons that I've been, you know, contacting you and trying to get you on the show, because what you did was just super cool. Because a lot of people put it out there and then they don't follow up. But a high school kid from Texas asked you to go to the prom, and you responded with, well, if you get so many thousand tweets in the next time frame, I will go with you. And he did, and you went with him, right?
Yeah. So I was sitting in class one day. I'm still a student. So I was sitting in class, not paying attention like usual. And I got a message on my Texans Twitter, and he was like, if I get 10,000 retweets, will you please go to prom with me? And I know that to go to prom, you have to be under 21.
Right.
And luckily, I was under 21 for like 4 more months or something.
Oh, lucky
and
him.
I was like, yes, absolutely. That sounds like fun. If you get the retweets, I'll do it. And then I got approval, and it kind of was really slow at first. I got like a couple hundred retweets, and then at the end of the day, it had like maybe 1,000. And the next day, I woke up, and he was like 12,000.
Wow.
It was unbelievable. It just took off.
Well, what's great is the offer was cool and all that, but you actually went through with it, and that's just
super
cool.
Yeah, I mean, of course,
cool
I'm not going to make a promise and then.
Yeah, that's awesome. So tell us the truth.
There's a lot of people that do that.
Did you go party it up with the kids after? You're like, yeah, back in high school.
No, I did not. I left the prom. I went to the prom for like an hour.
Okay.
If I get 20 retweets.
If I get 20.
Go ahead, Johnny.
No, I can't. Easy. Yeah, I got my father-in-law and my wife. I'm holding back so much right now. You're very beautiful, Caitlin.
Thank you.
Now, what drove you to be a cheerleader in the first place? I mean, what makes a woman want to be? Because, you know, it's not, like I said, it's not like it was before. You go out there on Sunday, you cheer, and you go home. It's a rigorous schedule now. What makes a beautiful woman like yourself, a smart woman, obviously, want to do something like that, knowing what it's going to cost? Do you go in there thinking, well, this is going to build my career for whatever I want to do after, or you just love sports, or you love dancing, or a combination? What really drives someone to want to do that?
Well, honestly, going into it, I didn't realize it was going to be such a time commitment, but it really it wasn't that bad. I enjoyed it. I loved being around all my teammates all the time. And I've been a cheerleader since I was 4 years old. Like, it's just who I am. I've I am, like, I'm known as Caitlin the cheerleader. And I, but what I did growing up was, like, all-star cheer, like, competitive. I flip, and I tumble, and I get thrown in the air, and I do that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I had always been told, you should try out for the Cowboys cheerleaders. You should try out for the Cowboys
cheerleaders. Yeah, you should have.
But
Josh is a Cowboy fan.
I'm a Cowboy fan.
I can't stand the Cowboys.
Oh, no!
I knew I loved
Come
you!
On!
I'm a huge sports fan. I've always been really into baseball, but I'm also super into football. And I, even since I was in, like, since I started watching football in, like, sixth grade, I just hated the Cowboys. I really don't know why. I just don't like
Caitlin,
them.
I have to play this because you just said that.
Everybody hurts.
He just broke his heart.
Sometimes.
What, is she married? I didn't hear. I didn't have my headphones.
No, she hates the Cowboys.
Oh. Everybody hates the Cowboys.
Plus, their uniforms are slutty uniforms, right, Caitlin? They're just slutty uniforms, right?
I have nothing against the cheer team. I'm not a fan of the football team.
That's right.
But anyway, so I've always been told I should cheer for the Cowboys cheerleaders. And then I told them, you know, I don't want to cheer for that team because I would be on the sidelines probably rooting for the other team.
Atta girl.
And
you probably should have just
and
because
so
of that.
Everybody's like, oh, well, go cheer for the Texans. They have a cheer team. And so I kind of looked it up and decided I'd go for it. And awesome. I didn't decide. I was trying out to like maybe like a month before. And I got my pictures done last minute and my outfit last minute. And I went in there with my best friend and we just, I don't know, tried out.
Knocked
it
out. That's fantastic.
It was the best thing that ever happened to me.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
You get to do a lot of things. Probably things that you hadn't thought were going to happen, but I'm sure visiting, I saw pictures where the Texas cheerleaders went to you know, the children's hospitals and visited you know, cancer patients and stuff like that.
That's always my favorite.
Yeah, it seems to be, but that's not something you thought was, you know, you were signing up for and stuff like that. But to do charity work and to give back is something that is really inspiring to people who, you know, you guys aren't just pretty faces. You're people and that you want to give back to the community and you do a lot of that kind of charity work, right?
Yeah, we really do. I wasn't expecting any of that when I came in onto the team. And then to see all of the events that we got to do, like I got to go to the hospital and so many different times and meet little kids that were fighting cancer and like to see their faces when we walked in and like give them a pair of our pom-poms and just make their day. Like that's not something that you can ever forget. That's a really special thing to experience.
I agree with you. That's fantastic. That's awesome. I had another question for you. Again, we're talking with Caitlin, former Texans cheerleader here. And, you know, everyone kind of wonders, everyone, you know, would love to, you know, what's J.J. Watt like? What's these players like? What kind of access do you guys have, you know, being around the stadium, mm-hmm. you know, being there at games, doing your practices and so forth? What kind of access do you guys have with the players? And do you like that kind of access? Do you wish there was more? Is there any interaction? What's your interaction with, like, with the team?
We are contractually, like, not allowed
really?
To talk to the players. We can't have any outside contact with them, but we do certain like appearances that the players will be there, like reading rallies. Like Dwayne Brown's huge with the United Way in their reading rally, so I did several appearances with him. We did appearances at like fast food places, and there would be players there. So you see them and you get to do appearances with them, but you can't have any contact with them, can't follow them on any social media. But I think it's better that way. It keeps us focused on what we're doing rather than trying to meet J.J. Watt or Brian Cushing.
Did you know that going in, or did that kind of bum you out once you found that out?
No. Oh, I already knew that.
Okay.
I didn't go into it planning on meeting any of the players, but I wouldn't be surprised if some girls go into tryouts.
So they actually told
sure
you,
they, do,
they,
right?
they contract, you guys cannot have contact with them outside, even outside of...
Right.
Wow,
we
that's amazing.
We can't have any personal contact with them, and if we do an appearance with them, we can only talk about the Texans. We can't talk about anything.
Yeah, well, good personal. For you now. You're
but,
not a Texas
But like I said, I think that's a very good idea. It keeps
sure.
us
yeah.
on track.
Now, you said you're a baseball fan. Are you an Astros
yes.
fan? If you are, I'm sorry for you, but what is your favorite team?
You know, I grew up in Kansas.
Oh.
And so I've got a soft spot for the Royals.
Royals, all
but
right.
I also have a friend that pitched for the Cardinals. He actually got traded to the Braves, but I became a Cardinals fan because of him, and now I'm a huge Cardinals fan. And I do like the Astros, but it's kind of out of pity. want them to be. I just so badly want them to be good.
I know. I know. The days of Bidge, the days of the bees are gone with Biggio and Bagwell, and
the glory days are gone.
Yeah. Okay, so
yeah, it's like every time we get a good player, they get rid of him. We had Bud Norris, and he's gone. Yeah. We had J.D. Martinez, who was decent, and he's gone.
She knows her
Jared
players,
Kozak's gone.
Yeah, I agree. Well,
I mean, we have George Springer, and we have
yeah, Altuve. You got Altuve.
Better George than
you
Jerry.
Got Altuve too.
Altuve.
Yeah, looking good.
So.
Everyone loves it. You said Colonel, you hate the Cowboys. Trust me, we're getting lots of tweets
Colonel
right now for that.
In, man, I love her.
Yeah, everyone loves her now. Thank you. Appreciate it.
So now, if I'm not mistaken, you left the cheerleading squad to pursue to go back to school, I think, and to pursue a career in broadcasting. Is that not correct?
Yes, I love sports. I've loved sports since I was really young because I played softball. I think that's kind of where it started.
Softball, I love you. My daughter was a softball player, and Steve's daughters were softball players. That's fantastic. I love softball.
Yeah, go. So I guess it kind of like playing softball made me love baseball and watching baseball, and then being on the sidelines of football made me love football. And I know a lot about it, and I love the statistical side of it. And I would just love to be like on the sidelines.
You have the knowledge. Just as your first appearance, I'm gonna let you know you're very good. You're on the radio. You got energy, and you obviously got the looks. I don't think you're gonna have any hard time finding out there. Aaron Andrews, get the hell out of the way. Caitlin's coming. Get out the way.
Aaron, Bobby.
Thank you so much.
Aaron tossed her nose. I can't handle that voice.
Exactly.
That bothers me.
Also, which we're gonna have, I want to let all our listeners and fans know, we're actually gonna be doing a special feature on Caitlin coming up here in the next week or two. So stick around on the website for that. So we have a good Q&A with her so you guys can get to know her a little more.
Absolutely.
It'll be good.
Absolutely. Hey, well, when you...
Question? Yeah, go ahead. Go. We got a question from... Go ahead, John.
Caitlin, I just wanted to get your opinion since you came from within the infrastructure on the cheerleading side. What is your opinion of the teams like the Buffalo Jills suing the team for... I guess they're saying that their rights were... violated. They were paid less than minimum wage with all the appearances and so forth. I think the Bengals also followed, and there was another team.
Yeah, there's a couple teams, out there.
What's your thoughts and opinion on that, knowing why you got involved with the organization to begin with from the start?
You know, I can't really speak much to it because I haven't been in their position, because with the Texans, I mean, obviously we didn't get paid like the players do. We made a much lower wage, but we didn't really do it for the money. We did it for the experience. And so we didn't have any bad experiences like that. I loved my coach, and I loved my teammates, and I loved how I was treated when I was with the organization. And I didn't mind the pay. It wasn't anything like that. From what I understand from the other teams, they didn't like the way that they were being treated, and that there was just some things going on the inside that they didn't like. So I can't really speak to it much because I didn't experience it, but it makes me sad that they didn't have the same experience being an NFL cheerleader that I did.
Appreciate that.
That's good. That's a good, great question.
Yeah, it was.
Thank you.
Okay, Caitlin, thank you so much for calling in. Really appreciate it.
You guys can make sure you go ahead and give your Twitter a shout-out.
@Caitlin_Beth3, right?
No, Caitlin Beth_3.
I'm sorry about
that. Yeah, and Caitlin is spelled Caitlyn. So just so you guys know, Caitlin Beth_3 on Twitter. Please follow her, support her.
Yeah,
and,
I'm really funny. Follow me.
She is. There it is. She is very funny.
Now I do. I have one question though.
Yeah.
Where's your accent?
What?
Where's your Texas accent?
I heard it.
I grew up in Kansas.
Yeah, Kansas.
You can still hear the accent, though.
You got a little. You can hear it, John. Yeah, you got a little bit of accent.
The only little bit of accent I have is I say y'all.
Yeah, there you go. There, I like to hear it.
But hey, good luck to you, and if there's anything we can do to help you, and you know, and when you make it big, and when you're on the sidelines at ESPN doing your thing, don't forget us.
Yeah, we'll support you in everything you do, Caitlin. Yeah, we're here to support you. Anything you need, you let us know, and we appreciate it.
Thank you so much for being on. Appreciate it, and we'll have you on later, man. I hope you're a friend, and you continue to call back, and we'd love to speak with you some more.
All right, I would love that. Thanks so much.
All right, Caitlin, thank you very much.
All right,
okay, guys. Great interview right there. She was fantastic. That was good questions. She was funny, energetic.
Yeah, very engaging.
Beautiful. She can bring the energy. I mean, I don't see why not. Just kick Andrews out of there. I'm telling you right now. Get her out of there. All right, guys. Well, let's take a break. That was good. We got to end on a break there. Let's
I love
go.
Mr. Awesome. My poor ass who's getting hate from the beautiful Caitlin Beth.
They have feelings, too.
Yeah. She hates the Cowboys. All right, guys. When we get back, we got shots coming up. Shot of the Week Award. Fill your shots up. Also coming up on the show, we got a baseball and Mexican minutes coming
Those
up here.
Minutos.
Yeah,
Mas
we're
going to
be talking.
Right?
It'll
be an hour
Lots
this week.
Of baseball for Renee. Send the questions in.
Well, in Mexican time, that's a minute. So.
We'll talk a little bit of NBA, a bit more on the Warriors. We'll talk about NHL playoffs right around the corner.
NHL, baby.
You got knocked the fuck out. Wild with Sports and a Bonehead coming up. We'll be back right after this.
Y'all know me, still the same OG, but I've been low key, hated on by most of these niggas with no cheese, no deals and no G's, no wheels and no keys, no boats, no snowmobiles and no skis. Mad at me, cause I can finally afford to provide my family with groceries. Got a crib with a studio and a saw full of tracks to add to the wall full of plaques. Hanging up in the office and back of my house like trophies. Did y'all think I'ma let my dough freeze? Hold please, you better bow down on both knees. Who you think taught you to smoke trees? Who you think brought you the ODs? Eazy-E's, Ice Cubes and D.O.C's, the Snoop D.O.G's, and a group that said motherfuck the police. Gave you a tape full of dope beats to bump when you stroll through in your hood. And when your album sales wasn't doing too good, who's the doc that he told you to go see? Y'all better listen up closely. All you niggas that said that I turn pop or the fur flop, y'all are the reason that Dre ain't been getting no sleep. So fuck y'all, all of y'all. If y'all don't like me, blow me. Y'all are gonna keep fucking around with me and turn me back to the old me.
Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. So what do you say to somebody you hate?
What?
Or anyone trying to bring trouble your way? One of his off things in the blood of your way? Yep. Just study your tape of NWA. One day, I was walking by with a Walkman on, when I caught a guy, give me an awkward eye,
you look
strangled him off in the parking lot, but it's dark and I don't give a fuck if it's dark. I'm harder than me trying to park a Dodge, but I'm drunk as fuck, right next to a humongous truck in a two-car garage. Hopping out with two broken legs, trying to walk it off. Fuck you too, bitch, call the cops. I'ma kill you and them loud-ass motherfucking barking dogs. And when the cops came through, me and Dre stood next to a burned-down house with a can full of gas and a handful of matches, and still weren't found out.
Right here.
So from here on out, it's the chronic two, starting the day and tomorrow's anew. And I'm still local enough to chuck you to death with a Charleston chew. Slim Shady, hotter than a set of twin babies. And a Mercedes Benz with the windows up when the temp goes up to the mid-80s. Calling men ladies. Sorry, Doc, but I've been crazy. There's no way that you can save me. It's okay, go with him, Haley. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre.
If it was up to me, you motherfuckers stop coming up to me with your hands out, looking up to me like you want something free. When my last CD was out, you wasn't bumping me. But now that I got slow company, everybody wanna come to me like it was some disease. But you won't get a crumb from me, cause I'm from the streets of
Compton.
I told them all them little gangsters, who you think helped mold them all? Now you wanna run around talking about guns like I ain't got none. What you think, I sold them all? Cause I stay well off. Now all I get is hate mail all day saying Dre fell off. What, cause I've been in the lab with a pen in the pad trying to get this damn label off? I ain't having that. This is the millennium of aftermath. It ain't gonna be nothing after that. So give me one more platinum plaque and fuck rap, you can have it back. So where's all the mad rappers at? It's like a jungle in a habitat. But all you savage cats know that I was strapped with gas when you were cuddling a cabbage patch.
Nowadays everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips. Just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre.
Yeah! are here this hump day every Wednesday, 6:30 to 8:30. Big shout out. This segment, Conan, is going to be brought to you by Fireman's Brew.
Yes, sir.
The official beer sponsor of the sportscast. The Menage a Trois of beers. Check them out. They're blondes, they're redheads, and they're darks. All your local grocery stores. They even got them at your baseball stadiums. They're at Staples Center now. Firemansbrew.com, guys, for all the locations. They have been with us for a while. Support them. Real firefighters made this beer right here.
Yes, we're absolutely. So, and I believe
a portion of it goes to
a
the
large portion of the proceedings go to firefighters, families who have lost their lives, protecting us and doing what they do. Yes. So if you're gonna buy beer, buy it from Fireman's Brew. You'll be helping the families of firemen worldwide.
And they'll be out at the second annual Sportscast Golf Tournament coming up.
Serving up
May
Fireman's
2nd.
Brew,
guys, right around the corner. You only got about 2 weeks to sign up here. We've had a lot of people sign up already. Limited tickets are there, so you must sign up by April 20th.
420, we made it just like 420. Oddly enough.
My boy Steven Dan.
Steve Twain and Dan. All right. Hope you're not golfing in front of me. All right. I know.
You heard, right? One of our listeners.
So, guys, sign up today at sportscastlife.com, guys. Mark Long will be there from MTV once again. Pocket Protein will be giving out free samples.
Yep.
We'll be having pictures being taken. It's a fun time. Renee was out there last year with us. So, it's only $90, guys. Includes lunch. You guys get free range balls before, so you can come and warm up. Also gives you guys raffle tickets. We gave away a bunch of stuff last year. Golf bag was taken away by our own Jeff Pratt.
Yes.
We've had free golf lessons, free golf rounds at various golf courses.
Absolutely. We have
sleeve
gift
of balls,
cards for dinners and stuff.
Bunch of stuff going out, so it's a fun day.
What hole's the shot girls on?
Shot girls are on
10th hole.
10th hole, which is going to be closest to the pin, and you get your lunch right there. So you swing around, beers,
you
girls.
You get your lunch after the ninth hole. You get your hamburger. Fantastic. You pull up. There's boobs, beer, and raffle tickets and shots at the 10th hole.
Yeah.
All right there. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Mary's boobs will not be there. I'm sorry.
Yes, everyone's
fans.
Disappointed. My sister won't be there. Sorry.
Mary's boobs won't be there, but...
But we'll have plenty of wives. My wife will be there. Your wife will be there. Johnny's wife will be there.
Absolutely.
Joey's wife's going to help out. Taryn's going to be there. English Linder's going to be there.
Taryn's
helping
got enough boob for everybody.
Yeah,
so
we've got enough boobs going around for the tournament. So check it out today, guys, May 2nd. All right, shot of the week or shit of the week. If you guys got one, tweet us right now or call the show at 818-435-8423. Renee, I'm going to go to you first here. What do you got here?
I got one of each. Okay. My shit of the week goes out to cancer because it took my aunt's life on Monday.
I'm sorry, bud.
I've lost a couple of family members to cancer, and
I'm sorry about that.
Morning, found out my aunt passed away, and my shot of the week goes out to her life and her memory, and my aunt Franny. She was a great human being, and God bless her soul. She's now in the heavens.
All right, cheers up to that, man. Cheers up to that.
Well, we got another one on that same note. Okay. Unfortunately, Crispy Rice lost his godmother to cancer this week also. So that's his shit of the week.
You guys are in our prayers. Right.
But he does have a shot of the week for baseball being back.
Okay.
Okay. My shot of the week, I have two of them.
Okay.
First one, they're both golf related. First one is going to Mr. Jack Nicklaus.
Yeah, you have a picture of him. You can throw it up. Right
that in. Ever okay. lived. Yeah. 75 years old.
At the Masters,
at Augusta. Drops a freaking hole-in-one.
He dropped a hole-in-one.
Three-four tournament.
Absolutely ridiculous.
That's his first ever hole-in-one at the Masters.
Yeah, I got a little something for you. You bring that up. What's even funnier about that is he called the shot before he
That's what you were saying.
So I got a little bit of him. He's on ESPN here with Scott Van Pelt, and this is before he got his hole-in-one here.
How's that?
I'd love to see it. I'm sure the folks at home
Absolutely.
Would.
They'll
start over
We'll try to get one for you.
Here we go.
Maybe a hole-in-one. How's that?
I'd love to see it. I'm sure the folks at home
Absolutely.
Would as well.
We'll try to get one for you.
That's my boy, Jack.
Well, there you go, Jack,
right
baby. Hook it.
75, wow.
And he calls his shot as a hole-in-one, man. I mean, the guy's just magical.
Camilo Viegas had two hole-in-ones today, but who the fuck cares?
Yeah, no, everyone's like,
he should have done it like Babe Ruth. Dude.
He's not worthy. Who the hell cares? Jack Nicklaus got a hole-in-freaking-one.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
And tomorrow for the first round, the ceremonial
Masters,
the ceremonial tee shot for the Masters is going to be Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, and Gary Player.
Okay.
Holy shit.
All right.
They're going to hit the ceremonial first tee shots. The second one is going to Brittany Lincecum.
Okay.
She was playing at the women's first major. It used to be called
Any
the Dinosaur.
Any relation to a Lincecum on the
No,
Giants?
It's spelled different.
Okay.
But she's playing at the A&A tournament, which used to be the Dinosaur. It's the first major down in Mission Hills. Mm-hmm. 18th hole. She's two shots down, right? Pulls a fucking eagle out of her ass to get into a playoff.
And you see, I've watched a couple shows late
and then
at night.
You
girls
see,
do that.
And you, she's a big girl. You see her and Stacey Lewis playing the playoff holes, right?
Yeah.
Stacey Lewis is not looking at the crowd, not acknowledging the crowd. Way too serious to acknowledge anybody there. Brittany Linson comes high-fiving, walking to the walk up to fairway. Yeah. So for her to win with an eagle to get to the playoffs. Yeah.
You watch women's golf live?
Sure. Why not?
Just asking that question.
What's wrong with women's golf, man?
There's nothing wrong with it.
There's
just
some
the question.
Hot, smoking hot
Why
women.
So offensive? Why are you getting so defensive over it?
Because you're a dick.
Why? Just ask the question.
Yeah, you asked it. You asked
I just
question
wanted to know what that's what you do on your weekends. You watch women's golf.
I have a friend who lives on the 11th hole of that course.
Okay.
Okay?
I'm just asking a question. You're getting upset right now. All I do is ask a simple question to you.
What is wrong with women's golf?
Nothing's wrong with women's golf.
They wear short skirts.
You're making something up right now about women's golf. All I did say ask you a question.
Hey, they're athletic people too. But for her to come back and drop an eagle and then win a playoff, awesome. That's her second open win. Good for her. That was cool.
All right, good stuff. Steve, you got a shot over there? Anyone you want to give a cheers to?
Anybody for
anything.
Anybody
you want to give a cheers up for anything?
Who had a good
week?
Speaking
of the mic, twist the mic over to him. What do you got, Steve?
Just who had a good week?
How about for being into the show? Being in the show, just say cheers.
I'm here.
Yeah.
And I brought booze.
You brought booze. There
you go. See? Send the week to
myself. He brought the shot.
And I think Hal Hargrave's going to call in, a friend of mine. So
awesome. Okay, awesome. Yeah, we're in a minute for Shots Up. God, I love today's show. Fantastic. All right. You got one for us, Sean?
I
got
to give a shot to Christy. She passed her,
yeah!
her finals there. 93.75.
Yeah,
she did it. Yes. Proud of her.
The kids were happy right there. Thank
Definitely.
God.
That's awesome.
And I hit a trifecta today.
What'd you do?
I hit a trifecta. I actually just got confirmation on a triple deal, closing account in Napa, Beaverton, and Langley, British Columbia.
Triple play. Oh, Johnny, you're set, bro.
I'll help you with the Napa one.
There you go. I'll help you with the Beaver one, whatever you got, Beaver.
That's what I'm talking about.
I bet you closed that deal, John.
Beaver Eaters unite, baby.
Yeah, he's the Beaver Eater over there. That's one term. All right, so what do you got, Johnny Ice?
Sucks every time it comes around to me because everybody's kind of stolen my stuff. Masters, obviously,
okay.
Starting tomorrow. Nicholas with his
hole-in-one.
Amazing hole-in-one.
Okay.
My wife, obviously, for passing her test.
Okay.
Two stolen right out from under me. I got to give one to my cousin who just found out he's having another baby.
Oh, congratulations.
So
I'm
along
sorry
with
for
death
you.
Comes life.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, that's great. Know? That's good.
It was supposed to be a lot better than that, but you guys stole my
No problem, brother.
Stuff.
No problem.
Well, hey, and Duke won.
Dang it.
Hey. And Duke.
You fucked
Duke.
It up.
And Duke.
Fucked him up.
I'll take the Duke.
Duke. I'll take the Duke.
I take Duke.
All right, guys, I've got a shot and a shit coming up. I've got my first shot goes to Russell Westbrook. You can check out the story at the
I was
going to
do that one, too.
He won a Kia for his All-Star MVP. And as I wrote, it's not like Russell Westbrook really needs a Kia. He's probably got a Porsche, a
he's
BMW,
not
going to
drive
Mercedes,
a Kia
a
minivan.
Maserati.
Sorry.
So this gesture is kind of like, yeah, it's kind of like getting off
no,
my property. I don't
cool.
want a Kia on my
it's
property.
It's still cool to think
it
about.
Is. But when you think about it, it's like, really, I don't got room in my garage for the Kia next to the Maserati. So I don't think that's going to happen. But he ended up giving his Kia to a single mother of two children, so it's fantastic.
19-year-old mother of two. Yeah.
So it's a good gesture.
She thought she was on Canon camera, huh?
Yeah, you can check out the video on our site, so check it out there.
Where's the site?
Sportscastlife.com. Next one coming up, we got Louisiana. These kids are just my idols because it's back in college. Louisiana college kids pulled over while transporting over 100 cases of Natty Light on their way to Alabama spring break.
100 cases of Natty Light.
100 cases of Natty Light.
That is some beer shit.
They're just
baby.
Partying up.
That's
on.
Some serious
Let me
beer
give you the
shit.
Let me just give you a story real quick. Four college students from Louisiana were on their way to spring break in Gulf Shores of Alabama. The kids were driving the truck, pulling a trailer. They were pulling a trailer full of beer.
Rednecks unite.
With expired tags. So they're just going all out, okay? These kids are awesome. They're pulled over on I-10. The police searched the trailer. They found a spring break party chest. Now, this is what they had in this. They just rented a U-Haul trailer, hooked the sucker up, and filled it with beer. They had 118 packs of Natty Light. They had they had 10, 12 packs of Corona. They had a dozen bottles of Jack and a couple bottles of vodka. and what appears to be a single box of wine.
For the pussies in the crowd.
It's Franzia. It's that Franzia.
Franzia boxes of wine for the pussies in the crowd.
No word on whether the kids were planning to drink it or sell the booze. Either chance is 50-50. They're going to do one of the two. But that's, seriously, those guys get my shot.
Like Steve asked.
For having the ball. So, running, you all got to be.
Out of dime plates. That's awesome. Steve's question was, well, what are they going to do on Saturday?
Yeah, that's the first night, right? That's the first night. That's fantastic. And then I have a shit of the week. It's going to be for none of these guys. I just don't understand how these NFL draft people, these college athletes going into the NFL draft, get busted for this stuff day in and day out. But
Merry Christmas! Shitter was full!
Shitter is full this week with my shit of the week, which is going to be for, sorry, I have to bring it up here. PJ Williams, Florida State cornerback, and potential second round pick, getting picked up, arrested for DUI.
Yep.
He's an idiot, dude. It's like, come on.
Okay, real quick, two more on Twitter.
Future's right ahead of you. Come on. Yeah, get Twitter.
Two more on Twitter because you know we have to do that. From EJ Joe 2, Wisconsin for their run in the NCAA tournament. And Mr. Awesome checks in. My shot of the week goes for my son for starting to walk. And I'm not sure about this one. To my daughter for overcoming her fear and nailing her back tuck.
Whoa. I don't know.
Wow.
I don't know. All I got to say is,
take that, Jesus.
Take that, Jesus.
Is that something slang?
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know. Hey. But shots up. Let's hear the shots.
All right, let's hear the shot song.
Shots, 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 everybody. Shots, 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 everybody.
The chicken cock?
That's more chicken cock.
I told you not to give me more.
You got
the cock.
More chicken cock juice sliding down your throat, Johnny. Oh no, I missed one. I'm sorry. Ed from Arizona.
Dude, I've had enough of the cock, dude. I can't take any more cock in my mouth. I can't.
Ed, you better watch it. There's some sound drops coming.
I know. You got the new intro line.
Oh, I forgot one. Ed.
Yeah, I know.
Ed from Arizona. Yeah. And the Colonel. Shot of the week to Johnny Ice for teabagging Eric Scott Smith. I don't know.
Did you teabag Scott
Smith
today?
I'm not sure what's going on with that.
Actually, he teabagged me. What? Yeah. Oh, my God.
You were the bagger?
Oh,
you were the bagger, and he
it's
was the baggy.
Instagram.
Yeah, who was the baggy?
If you want to go, if you want to see it, go on the Heidi and Frank Instagram at Heidi and Frank, and you'll get to see it.
Well, tell him to suck my balls.
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah. We got a phone call? All right, we got a phone call coming up on the sportscast. You guys want to call the show? 818.
So what's up with Eric?
435-8423.
Is Eric packing or not, Johnny?
Is he packing, Johnny?
Is Eric packing or not?
What did you think?
Yeah, he had a nice tea bag.
That's a drop. That is a drop right there. That is a drop. All right, caller.
You're not
going to
get this shit on ESPN. Yeah, yeah.
You
are not going to get this on ESPN.
I'll
Sorry,
be surprised
guys.
If our caller's still with us. Caller, who we got in the line?
Hey, it's Paris. I had to call back, man.
Oh,
what's up?
What's going on?
What's up, Paris?
Listen, hey, I got to do two shits and one shot.
All right.
Oh, nice call. Hang on. Let me play the music for you.
Merry Christmas. Shitter was full.
All right. What do you got?
What are your shits?
Hey, the first one, man, I want to, my condolences to your aunt, man. Cancer fucking sucks.
It does, yes, man. Sir.
Yeah, it's taken a couple family members.
We had a stint in our family, man, for about like 2 months. There were like five different cancer deaths within like an 8-week period. It was ridiculous, bro. So I definitely second that, man. Cancer really sucks, man. If you guys ever have anything that for like any events where you need transportation to and from for any type of cancer type events or whatever, man, I'm willing to bring the SUV out, man, free of charge. You definitely help do something like that, man.
Thank you, right on, brother.
That really touched home, which is why I had to call back and share that with you guys.
Right on, brother.
Thank you, brother.
Second shit of the week goes to the idiot that dropped the N-bomb after Kentucky lost.
The Harrison twin. What a dumbass.
I hope you go on the very last round, if at all, you bum. That was ridiculous.
All right, I'll play this one for you.
Bonehead.
Yeah, he's a bonehead of the week right there, man.
All right.
And definitely my shout out has to go, and you know, very few of us brothers watch golf, so don't you guys give me shit about that. Hey, I was
one of those golf or men's golf?
Hey,
it wasn't because I was bedridden from the limo accident. I was one of those at home today watching the par 3 tournament live, and shouts out to the Golden Bear for dropping that ace.
Yeah, attaboy.
Hey, Paris, I have this drop for a reason, man.
I love black people!
I mean, come on.
That's all right. Be proud of your golf,
yeah,
love.
Be proud.
Stand
man.
Up, brother.
Yeah.
Stand up.
Hey, and on that note, did you guys see where Tiger almost nailed a hole in one and the guy jumped like 50 feet in the air and squatted down and was like, oh,
yeah,
man, I almost made it. If he sucks tomorrow on Friday, I don't want to hear shit about your back hurt.
All right,
I know nothing about no asthma.
Hey, man, thanks for checking back in with us. We appreciate it.
Hey, and I'm getting the Twitter's up right now. I'm just trying to find a legitimate picture. You know, they call me the Black Jason Statham at LAX.
Oh, I'm
trying to pick one of my better pictures with a nice suit on to put it up on Twitter. But it's Paris the Driver, all capitals, no spaces at Twitter, man, you guys.
Awesome.
All right, cool. We'll follow you up, man.
You got a follower,
Johnny.
Johnny's on it right now.
All right, bud.
P-A-R-R-I-S-T-H-E-D-R-I-V-R, Paris the Driver.
Whoa.
Okay, cool. Boston. We got another call. We got another phone call.
Crispy's on.
Oh, Crispy Rice. What's
going
on,
here
buddy?
We go.
What's up, guys?
What's going on, my
brother?
What's
up, brother? You what's up? Talk to
How
us.
How you doing?
We're doing fantastic. How about yourself?
It's my first chance to catch up live with you in the new studio, so congrats, everybody.
How am I looking, buddy? How am I looking?
I know
we met at the Morongo Casino for Heidi and
Frank.
I
can't believe you came
from
my loins.
Good? Am I looking good?
Yeah, you're looking a little shaggy with the dew there, Josh.
Oh, I know. See? I need to get it cut
See?
Off. I'm sorry.
That's what I'm saying.
He has,
hey, I don't
want to
throw you guys throw a monkey wrench in whatever you got going on, but I'm a week behind. I just listened to last week's podcast.
That's what I heard about you. You have a week behind.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah. All his friends are behind
wait,
him.
Wait a second. Bud, that was fucking quick, all right? I'm going to give that to you. That was fucking quick.
What's
well,
up, though?
Anyway, I just listened to last week's show.
Yeah.
And I had like three rants. I wish I could have called in last week live because I could have just like teed off on three different topics.
What, your wrestling topic? I know you had that one, right?
There's one.
All right, so are wrestlers athletes or not?
Hell yeah.
No, they are athletic.
No, they're athletic.
They're
athletic.
Bro? Bullshit,
yes.
Josh, none of us can do that.
That's true. They're just really pumped up soap opera actors that are athletic.
I don't care.
They're not athletes.
It's all fun, dude, but none of us can do that. I went up to the Bay Area for WrestleMania weekend. I went to four live events, and that shit kicked ass.
All right. Well, you know what, Chris? We're going to have to get a beer and discuss this.
Okay.
All right, buddy. Hey, well, baseball's back, man.
Yeah. Can I shout out on two other quick topics?
Yeah, go ahead.
Last week, Knocker was arguing about the NBA having like a weak Eastern division.
Yeah,
and
for the last 15 years.
Losing records getting in to the playoffs.
Yeah.
Well, last year I made that same argument about baseball, and you guys like dissed all over me. I think that all four major league sports that we have here in the States, it should all be by total wins or some kind of seed number, you know. And I'm tired of losing teams getting into the playoffs for all sports.
Well, I'm with you. I think first and second place, if you're going to have divisions, they have to mean something. So first and second place should get in, but after that, it's best records. Period. You know, you just seed with best records regardless of conference.
Yeah, it's same with baseball, you know, divisions, conference, whatever, hockey, anyone.
Okay, give us your third. What's your third rant?
The third one was you and Knocker, I think, argued for like 5 or 10 minutes last week about the kid who they were watching, recruiting for
Jameis Winston. Yeah, Jameis Winston NFL investigators. Yeah, follow him all over the place.
And there was one point that neither of you made that you said, well, if they want guaranteed money, then you should be able to follow somebody like that, right?
Right.
Well, then just don't give anyone guaranteed money. I think all these fuckers shouldn't have guaranteed money.
Well, I agree with that, but the agents and the union have brought it to where that is. I agree with you. I don't think anybody who hasn't played a down in professional football should be guaranteed anything.
Right.
You know, we give you. I think they should have a standard contract. If you're a first round pick, this is what you get, and if you're a second round pick, this is what you get. And if you want big money, then show me. You know, a guy that's been here 10 years.
I would even go a step further. I don't think anyone who's been in the league, you know, for multiple years should be guaranteed. I hate guarantees altogether. If you fuck up in your personal life, then you're going to pay the price.
I don't have a problem with that.
I like the old I can't remember his name right now. But if you read the book, it's called I believe One in a Million, and he used to own the San Diego Chargers, and that's what he did. 1 year contracts, bro. It's best for me, yeah, and it's best for you, because if you have a great year, then I got to pay you next year. If you have a shitty year, then I don't have to pay you. But you know, I don't want none of this guaranteed money, 3 year contract. And John Jefferson, back in the day, you know, negotiated, came in, he wanted to renegotiate a 4 year contract, and he said, okay, I'm going to do it, but the first time you come into my office to say you don't like your contract, you're gone. And John Jefferson, who could have been a Hall of Famer, who could have been one of the best receivers in the history of the NFL, ended up in Green Bay and retiring 2 years later. So I agree with you. Nothing should be guaranteed.
Yep.
Yeah, it sounds great to me. You know, I think the fans will still be there for you in the long run. And if you guys want to make the big bucks, then you better be a responsible adult, man.
I agree. No, that's a good point, man. All right, well, Crispy Rice, man, we miss you, buddy. Make sure you guys call in next week and catch up on the shows, man.
All right, guys. Take care, man. Good to catch up with you again.
You too, right, my brother. Appreciate it, man. We love you, man. Thank you. All right, guys. Well, later. I'm going to go to break here because I want to get a big baseball segment in. So we got shots up here.
Yes,
we'll take them just after the break. When we come back, guys, big baseball segment. We're going to get into
big
our
ball segment.
Yeah, big balls
it's
with
the
Renee.
Big ball it's segment
Pitch
with
Riz,
Renee.
Big banal, big ball segment. We're going to talk some baseball predictions
Can
coming
handle
up.
It?
We've got beer prices. How much is your favorite team selling the beer for?
No shit, dude.
I
got to
tell
it.
You right now, those people in Cleveland are getting real drunk right now. Get some cheap beers out there in Cleveland.
Woo!
We'll talk about that and more. Last half hour coming up here on the Sportscast. We'll be back. Stay right there.
Sitting in the Civic, my flows are unimaginable. Hannibal Lecter, shit. Eating MCs for breakfast, bitch. Since I was born and touched the mic the first time, it's been a problem. Your life was a mistake, your pop should've wore a condom. You niggas think you hard, I think you better come harder. I leave rappers confused like Will.i.am Barber. Fucking with looters, not a great look. A verse will make your fans unfriend you on Facebook. Click. My styles are going in the label, so if stars want a war, I'm they daddy like Darth Vader. And since I'm always high, it's kinda hard to overlook me. For over 100 stacks, it's kinda hard to overbook me. And a whole nother house for my cars is on my checklist, cause the fit 'em in one garage is like a nigga playing Tetris. But they say patience is a virtue, cause I got your bitch staying out way past the curfew. Guess I was a thief that got away with these words, slanging chickens out my whip like I've been playing Angry Birds. In a black Rolls Royce, dark night like Batman. Everywhere you turn, the ghost follows like Pac-Man. And I sleep with the John Dillinger, and always keep an eye half open like Forrest Whitaker. No, you boys ain't ready for combat. Be more worried if I renew my Def Jam contract. What path is he on? Opponents, I laugh and be gone. They handing in the towels like they work at Bed Bath and Beyond. But in the midst of all the melee, y'all niggas just bitches with dicks like Shanae. Your rap styles are phony, your lines are just dead. And I be on them lines like a nigga just played. I guess I'm trying to say I'm advanced, you intermediate. You wouldn't know the real me if your bitch Wikipedia'd it. Just know that I never tried to be hard, probably cause Mr. Glock 40's my security guard. You'll get chopped like judo. Gangs in my hood make you reverse and change your color like the blocks playing Uno. And yeah, some of my friends are still selling them drugs, but I just say they Weight Watchers like Jennifer Hood. They show me love, that's why I'll always stay repping until the death of me. Come on, rappers talk shit, but ain't nobody ever stepped to me. I hereby command all my fans to inject an overdose of Red Bull in your veins if you ever slept on me. Yeah, my mind is sharper than a guillotine, or the knives extended from the knuckles of Wolverine. Metro PCS.
Can you hear me now?
I changed my music up cause I was getting bored. You may not like the way I shoot, but my
the Sportscast. I want to thank all of our callers. It's been fantastic today. Phone lines blowing up. We appreciate it.
Yeah, it's been great,
you guys
great,
make the show what it is. We really appreciate it.
Caitlin,
we
do. Beth,
Caitlin,
three.
You were awesome.
That was
earlier,
awesome.
If you guys missed the interview, go back. Make sure you guys check us on iTunes. Subscribe to the show. Also on Podcast One, Stitcher Radio,
iHeart Radio.
Anywhere you guys can basically download or stream music, we are on there. So again, tell a friend, spread the word.
Spread something.
You guys can buy your t-shirts today too, you guys. Represent the Sportscast. We got t-shirts available at the Sportscast store.
That's my mantra, Steve. You ever heard that?
Sportscastlife.com. So check us out there. And also, guys, you want to call the show, we got about a half hour left, 818-435-8423, or tweet us. Just get it in right before.
Hey,
all right, guys.
Seriously, if you call the show, we're not like those other pretentious
we'll put you on.
Bullshit shows. The phone rings.
Yep.
We answer it.
Yep.
There's no screening. What do you want to talk to the guys
about?
We got a fan
time. Irish wants to know what hockey talked about. We're going to get hockey, basketball huge next week. I mean, playoffs start next week. We're going to get all into our picks. Go ahead, Steve-O.
But if you call in, you're getting on the air.
How call? What?
Seriously, if you call, you're getting on the air. There's none of this whole time, none of this bullshit. What do you want to talk to the guys about?
Yeah.
Well, they're on a different subject now. Fuck that. You call, we put you on the air. We want to know what you think. We want to know what's on your mind.
Okay.
And just bring it, man.
Well, then Chris on Twitter says, try cold cock whiskey if Josh wants a different cock. fucking cock jokes. Why'd you bring it? Who even gave you that? Where'd you even get that from?
Perfect Neighbor Rich.
Oh, Perfect Neighbor Ridge. Yeah.
I tried to bring Redbreast, but I couldn't find it.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, get the shot song ready because we got one more shot lined up.
And just because.
This is just shots.
Steve is here.
Go ahead, because Steve is here,
Mark,
baby.
We'll go do some real
Let's
stuff.
Let's go. Yeah. You got the song? Get the shots ready.
Everybody! Everybody!
Yeah, can we get a sound of that? You're putting that in the intro.
From a man that knows.
Yeah, from a man that knows. Wow.
That was definitely not cock.
Bring in the humor today. I love it. That was definitely.
Yeah, save that one for me, Renee.
Save that one. Oh, my God. Oh,
man, that was fantastic. When he texts me on a group text message, that's what I want.
That's what you want your ringtone to be?
I don't know. Hey, but Johnny. How good of a relationship do you have with your father-in-law?
Yeah, really?
Is he spending a lot of time with his left hand on your lap? I'm just saying. Every time I look, he's patting your right leg.
It wasn't me and you that had massages. It was me and your son.
That's true.
Yeah, okay.
Not that there's anything wrong with that. I'm just asking.
Wow, guys.
You guys are close, right?
Yeah.
All right, we're tight.
There's a special bond when somebody takes your daughter financially.
There's a financial bond.
You just landed three accounts, so go ahead, grab me wherever you want, father-in-law. Grab me wherever you want.
Oh, that's fantastic.
We're Italian. That's what we do.
That's what we do. So you know, familia.
That must be Southern Italian. I'm not sure about that.
Watch out for the kiss, because if you get the kiss, it's dead.
Oh, my goodness.
There is a lot of kissing in Italian,
The lips you got to worry about.
Yeah.
Hey, Molinari, right there, Italian, right there, Molinari.
All right, guys. Let's get into
Sports?
Sports? Baseball, baby. Baseball to Mexican Minutes today. All right, we got a lot going on in baseball right now.
So Monday was opening day.
It was.
Yep, and Dodgers got the win, Angels got the loss. And I'm excited for baseball to be back. Are you guys?
I'm very excited right now. I'm excited for what the Dodgers got going. Angels looking good, kind of both 1-1, okay starts. But I like where we're headed.
Rockies are starting out 3-0.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, that was wasn't expected.
How
that.
The Yankees doing?
A couple quick notes around the league.
Did they win tonight?
Yankees win tonight? I think they're losing tonight. Actually, I know they lost yesterday.
Who did?
Yankees.
They lost yesterday. They were up
yesterday
today.
And on opening day.
Yeah, they're up today though.
Oh, they are.
Yeah, they were up today. They came back, made a little comeback.
All right, just a couple
What's
quick
going
notes
on?
Around the league. Justin Verlander is going to go on the DL for the first time.
Like I said, he's screwing Kate Upton. Does he realize anyone really have pity for the man?
No.
Thank you.
No.
And then Matt Cain from the Giants is going to be on the DL also.
Really?
Yeah. He's got some elbow issues.
Who's going to be on the DL?
Matt Cain from the Giants. The Giants. Really
okay.
For, you know what, man? Go ahead. I don't want to interrupt your stuff. Yeah. Like Josh, I'm not going to interrupt your segment.
Shut up.
Anybody else want to chime in?
No. Yeah. Go.
Your face isn't on the logo, bitch.
And then the Padres, dude, they make a blockbuster deal at the night before opening day.
Right,
they
sure did.
Craig Kimbrell, the closer from the Braves, and Melvin Upton, the other Upton brother, the not-so-good one. So, yeah, they're
looking
pretty dangerous.
Well, he's named Melvin. What the fuck? Melvin. One guy's named Justin, the other guy's named Melvin. Right? Which one do you think was going to succeed?
Real quick, Renee, when they're thinking of Melvin as a baby name, like, do they talk about that? Like, hey, we
black.
Should name him Melvin?
And you're black.
You have 9 months and you come up with Melvin? It's probably pronounced weird, like, Melvin.
Melvin. No, it's not Melvin. It's Melvin.
It's like Donovan McNabb, right?
Yeah.
His name's probably really Donovan.
Donovan.
And you touched up a little bit about this off the air, but Matt Latos from the Marlins.
Throw up the picture of his face, dude.
He got rocked, dude, for 7 runs in the first inning against the Rockies.
He sported a 94.5 ERA.
Nice.
I would have done that for $5,000.
No shit. Worked that all year.
I could have gotten out of the first inning, I think, with maybe 5 or less.
Yeah, I think Mary could have an underhand.
Yeah, he's
crying.
He is crying in this picture.
There's no crying in baseball.
You have the drop, Josh. Come on. Find it.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I don't have it in front of my face. Come on.
I'm sorry. Jesus Christ. Mas.
That was my Mexican menu, but you wanted to talk about beer prices.
No, yeah, I have beer prices. I got much more baseball stuff. So,
cerveza.
Let's go.
A staple of baseball.
Real quick, Josh Hamilton won't be suspended for his drug abuse,
and
drug
I love
use.
It. The Angels are pissed off that he's not suspended.
Yeah, because they got to pay him the $25 million.
They're stuck for $83
million. He's like
the
second
first
highest paid player in the Angels,
And I bet you it'll happen again.
Yeah, it's going.
He has
a
history.
They're stuck for $83 million for the next 3 years with this guy.
Now, Wrigley Field. Wrigley Field, one of the oldest stadiums in Major League Baseball.
I think it's the oldest, that and Fenway.
Okay. It's going through some renovations now. Well, they didn't get the bathrooms finished by opening day.
Now
we've all been there. We've had the beers.
How do you not
Have
the bathrooms finished by opening day?
I mean, come on. You're outside. You're partying. You're outside having tailgating. Now you can check the pictures out. This is a real picture from the Cubs bathroom. They literally started peeing in cups in the corner because there's no stalls open.
That's what I would. Hell yeah. Fuck it.
You're playing swords in the corner with
gotta
cups?
Gotta go.
What is this?
Hey, at least they didn't pee on the wall. I commend them for being classy. At least they didn't pee on the wall.
Yeah, you know what? That's a good
Seriously.
Point.
Seriously. I would have spelled my name.
At least they should just leaked it out in the seat.
You know, go to the soccer, just whip it out your shorts.
I'd hate to mix up your beer in that cup holder for the other one. Oh, my God. Can you imagine?
Dumb and dumber.
I would have brought one back to my buddy be like, hey, man,
no,
I brought
your
beer.
If you're drinking Coors, you wouldn't notice.
That's when you buy the guy that's wearing the other team's uniform a beer.
Hey
bro,
want a beer?
I bought you a beer, man. I bought you a beer. Here you go. Yeah, there's two.
When you go dumb and dumber, officer, you don't want to drink that. Officer?
Well, I thought they stopped selling beer after the 17th. No, I know the guy. You can take it. I know the guy.
Yeah, he did. That's why it's warm.
It's one of the last ones. It was sitting out.
I had a girl drink my pee before. It's all right.
So,
wow.
Yeah, it's good. Wow. Right there. Sitting there. So what do Cubs do in Cubs fashion?
Now, wait. Whoa, no. Stop.
Yeah. Sorry.
Directly from your penis or out of a cup?
What? What? I missed what was going on.
What was that?
No, Johnny made a comment.
What did he say?
I had a girl drink my pee before.
What?
Yeah. It
you
was
married that girl, right? Christina?
Her dad is here. Her dad is here. Shut the hell up, man.
Ice. It was actually...
I gotta hear this, man. It's directly or
No. I was at a bar one night and it was packed and I really had to pee and I sucked down my drink real quick, so there was a lot of ice in it.
Right.
And
I thought it's a true story.
Well, I'll tell you why he knows this. So I peed in the cup. I took it and I didn't have a place to put it, so I just set it on the end of the bar.
You did not.
And it filled it right up the
top.
And my brother-in-law, his son, and his girlfriend walked up to where we were. And it's his ex-girlfriend now. It's okay. And she came up and she was hammered and she was like, oh, what are you drinking? I grabbed my drink. and took a big chug of it as I go,
but at the same time, yes.
Oh,
are you serious?
As I
bro?
Did that, yeah, she spit it back out.
Oh, yeah.
And
never. So the moral of the story is never drink a beer that you did not see poured.
It
right?
wasn't a,
right.
It wasn't a beer. It was, right? it was a Red Bull and vodka, and it came out looking like a Red Bull and vodka.
Oh my God.
Wow, Johnny, that's awesome.
That's wrong.
That is so wrong.
There
that
you
is
go.
So
and
wrong.
By the way, Yankees 4, Blue Jays 3. Five.
Yeah, oh, we there won! You go. Shout out to your son.
Shout out to Johnny.
Yeah, just, shout out to Johnny.
I think we need another Who is Johnny on that.
Yeah, who is Johnny Ice?
Who is Johnny
Ice?
God. All right, guys. Next up here in baseball. Guys, so we're talking about beers, right? We're talking about Pain
I don't know
beer.
What we're talking
yes.
about.
Well, how much do these things cost when you go to the game?
Too much.
Too much, right?
$9.75.
Now, you think if your team's good, okay, I can pay a little more for my beer, right?
Right.
Okay, the Phillies have sucked for a long time.
Yes, they have.
They're
they
the
have.
Third They're the third highest beer price in all of Major League Baseball. Wow. $7.75. I know,
You're stupid enough to go to a Phillies game. Exactly.
Next up, the Twins. When have the Twins what? Been good? $7.75 for a beer at the Twins game?
But how many ounces is that? Now, so you have to qualify this.
Oh, they, no, I have ounces. I have it broken down to how much it costs. $7.75
does not sound too bad for
numbers.
A beer.
I have the numbers. I have it broken down to how much it costs per ounce.
Okay.
Highest cost per ounce of
right,
beer
right.
is the Red Sox.
See,
at
that's
65
what I want
cents per ounce.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
The Mariners are next at 50 cents per ounce. The Yankees at 50 cents per ounce. The Marlins are 50 cents per ounce. They're the one that tie. Like, God, you got to go see the Marlins and I got to pay high priced beers?
Oh, shit, man.
But the lowest tier are the Angels.
Yes.
The lowest per ounce beer in the Major okay. League Baseball is 28 cents
yeah, already,
per ounce.
Already is cool.
Pandering to the Mexicans.
Oh, God.
Pretty much. Wow. We're trying to send them away from the Dodgers. Hey, come over here. Wow. We have
it's all the Tecate sales. It's all the Tecate sales.
The only Fenway game I've ever been to, I was at a Budweiser suite.
Yeah.
It didn't cost me shit. Best game to go to.
Best game to go to. Also up there are the Dodgers. Dodgers cost per ounce is 31 cents. So every ounce you're drinking at a Dodgers game costing you 31
yeah.
cents.
I stopped spending money. I do not spend a nickel at stadiums anymore. I cannot stand getting ripped off.
Yeah.
You know, I'll take the flask. You know, I'll put the flask in my butt crack yeah. and walk in waddling.
You know.
And if it's
wow, do you guys help each other out with that you know, one, or
if,
is it?
If you've been with me, flag. You've been with me.
I've never helped you put anything in your butt.
You've wow. been with me.
Hold that one.
But you've been with me at a hockey game and a late season game where yeah. I wear the big jacket.
Yeah, you have to.
I can fit a 12-pack yeah. in the sleeve,
oh,
right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Right?
You get very MacGyver-like when
exactly.
it comes to hiding beers.
Exactly. I can
beers.
Do that and fit the flask of vodka yeah. in my pants, slip and I
in.
Order one fucking 7-Up for
the
whole
socks,
night, right?
In the socks.
Always
in the socks,
use the wife's say. Cleavage.
Seriously.
Get like, the little bottles from the liquor store, put them in the your socks. The retrieval's fun. Never check your socks.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Wear snowboard socks. Yeah.
But I will not.
Yeah, wear snowboard socks, and you can fit so much stuff in those things.
I refuse to spend
them.
Money at a stadium anymore.
Okay, so
no,
is it,
we're smart.
Can I ask you this question? And we all have children. Now yes. I'm getting. Now we've all gone taking our children.
I don't have
two,
children.
Okay, well, two of you don't. Okay, and the four of you. Okay, now. Yeah. But now, when they were little and used to go to a game, now you say you don't want to spend money in there.
Right.
Am I a bad father if I chug a couple beers in the car before I walk in the game with my 7-year-old in the
God,
car
no.
next
no.
to me? Just give me some advice here, guys.
No.
As long as you give him the keys, you're okay.
Hey, Penny, you're driving
Penny, you're
home
driving.
Tonight. You can sit out. I'll push the gas. You just steer. You just steer.
Sit in my lap. They'll never know.
Yeah.
Then you get arrested
bad?
For being a pedophile.
I feel kind of bad because I'm going on Saturday. I'm going on Saturday to the Angels
right.
game. And, and like you said, I'm going to maybe buy two or three beers when I'm in there. Maybe spend like $25 on beers.
I would take a flask of vodka in my
But
hip.
Am I bad? Does that look bad in front of your kid?
She don't know yet. No.
Just say it's apple
only
juice.
Seven.
Say it's apple juice?
Yeah, it's only seven.
Apple juice.
Okay.
So then they want it.
Yeah. Like, hey, Dad, give me some of that.
And with
$4
your routine, she'll probably ask you, Daddy, why are you stopping at two?
When they get 16, it's beautiful because you hand them the keys before you walk in the restaurant and say,
You're driving.
You're driving. That's, yeah, exactly. Exactly. So
that's good.
Normal Angel game, you're in a 12-pack, well, Daddy. Why are you stopping at two?
Cheapest beers, though, in Major League Baseball. $4 a beer at the Diamondbacks and the Indians game. That's not bad.
But how many ounces? You're giving me prices, but I want to know ounces.
Oh, my God. It's a fucking 12-ounce beer. I ate 16 ounces.
Is it, or is it an 8-ounce beer?
Where is this? Who sells 8 ounces of beer?
I don't know. I'm asking you.
I think they're selling 20 ounces because I remember like $10 at the Bills game.
Yeah, right? Something like that. Like a regular beer, okay, is $4. That's not bad.
Not at all. Where is this?
Not at all.
At Cleveland and Arizona. Angels is $4.50. Astros is $5. You got a few other teams like the Rays, Cardinals, A's, Tigers.
So this is 16-ounce beer we're talking
about. But you
go
from $4 at like the Angels then all the way up to $7.75. That's a $3.75 cent hike.
Well, shit, go to Staples Center for a Laker game.
Huh? Yeah, exactly. Everyone's, sell a crowd at Boston. I'm going to raise those beer prices. That's why you go to Magic Mountain or Disneyland. A hot dog costs you $7 because you're going to buy it when you're there.
I'm sure it probably depends
on... No, I'm not.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
On drinking laws, too. I imagine, depending on what state you're in, because... Yeah, sure. about how much that they have to charge as far as tax-wise goes.
Okay, as far as their state regulations
that,
on it and
stuff.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah.
I could see that.
No, oh, I got all serious for a second.
Yeah. Whoa, hey.
Got all serious.
Yeah. All right, well, let's get
Where's
into
the
our...
Johnny we know?
Everyone wants to know our predictions. We do this every year. We're going to run through them. Give me a little background here. We got.
I predict I'm getting late tonight.
No, you're not. Oh, you won't even be able to get it up. You see how everybody said that like right at the same
time? Your wife's still working.
Yeah, she's still working. She's not even here. She's working that Hope Boulevard.
I know you're going to be missing me when you got that big, white, wrinkly body on top of you with this loose skin and old... Balls? Gross.
That was the best drop
right
there.
Let me qualify this. I didn't say I was going to be with somebody.
Oh, man. Well, we got an update. Angels are up 5-1 right now.
Nice.
So that's good. Dodgers are up 5-2.
I also have another update.
Okay.
Adrian Gonzalez of the Dodgers hit 2 home runs tonight. He hit a home run opening day, a home run yesterday.
Okay.
So he has 4 home runs in 3 games. He went 3-for-4 in the first
game.
3-for-4 yesterday.
Dodgers
and he's 2-for-4 today.
You know what was great?
2-for-3 today.
When he came up for the 4th time in the opener, he'd already had a single, a double, and a home run.
Yep.
No fucking way he's in the triple. He's the slowest bastard I have ever seen.
Unless that
ever.
Gets away from the outfielders.
Ever. Yeah. Somebody's going to have to hit the wall and die.
I have a nickname for him. Thumper. Like, here comes Thumper around in third.
He is the slowest.
But has he peed in a cup yet?
That's the question.
Yes.
And has the girl drank it? Has his wife drank it? Right? That's the other question. I'm disturbed at you, really. I kind of am at that.
Well, it wasn't my fault. She's an alcoholic and needed a fucking drink.
I don't have to attest to that. He's true. He's right. He was.
Yeah.
All right, let's go through our MLB predictions here.
Asked first.
What's in this?
I've seen just blackouts. Blackouts. Serious blackouts.
That's awesome. Fantastic, dude. It's right of a movie
dropped
right there.
His daughter.
It's so good.
She gets that.
She gets that like squinty, like that face on Dumb and Dumber. Like, it's like in your teeth and the gums.
In case you didn't know, this is a sports show.
Yeah, no, it's good. Yeah, we just got a tweet that said, the show's finally hit a wall. Yeah, we finally jumped the shark.
Yeah, we jumped the shark.
So let's get our predictions real quick. American League East knocker, who you think wins it? Orioles, Red Sox, Yankees, Blue Jays, or Rays? Who comes out this
year?
You
know who I'm going with. My Orioles, baby.
I've been
with the Orioles for 3 years, baby.
Yeah, you've been on that Orioles bandwagon.
And Renee, who you like? Back from suspension, baby.
I'm going Toronto. They made a lot of good moves in the offseason.
Okay.
And they look like a pretty deep lineup. They have some pretty good pitching.
All right,
good team.
You Yankee man, right?
I am, but I gotta go with the Orioles. I really think that this could be
Buck Showalter, man. He's turned that organization around down there. They got some good pitching down there too. Look good. All right, Johnny, you don't know anything about baseball.
Yeah, well, no, I got my Yankees hats at home.
Oh, my God.
I got my red one. I got my green one. I got my blue one.
Jesus.
I got my black one. So
even the kids just booed you right now. All right, I'm going to go actually with Boston. I think Boston pulls this out. I like what Boston's moves have done. I like their pitching staff a little bit. I like Porcello just signing a contract. And I like their offense a little bit. I think Boston somehow finds a way to get it done. Because the Orioles always choke in the end.
They lost to Philly.
Until they do it.
Well, you said who would win the division, not go to the World Series.
No, I'm saying I think Red Sox win the World. I think Red Sox win the division by the end.
All right.
All right, Central here in the AL. Detroit Tigers, Royals. Indians, White Sox, and Twins. Renee, who you got?
I say Tigers. They're just too dangerous of a team, man.
Price looked good in his first start already.
They have a lot of good players.
I think letting go of Scherzer's going to hurt him, though. That 1-2 punch of Price and Scherzer.
He didn't have a good day on opening day.
I know, against the Nationals. Yeah. For the Nationals. All right, so you're going Tigers, though?
I'm going Tigers.
All right, what do you got?
I think the Tigers have made their run. I think the Royals lost too many players.
Okay.
I'm going to go with the Dark Horse, and I'm going to go with the White Sox.
The White Sox, really?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, I think the White Sox have a good team.
Jose Abreu, man. Solid. Good player.
I think they have a solid team. I think that's a pretty crappy division. I think 85 wins will win that division.
Done, really? You're that down on the Tigers in that division?
Yeah, I just think that they just shot their wad and they didn't make it and they're rebuilding.
All right, what do you got, John?
I would go with the Tigers as well.
You go with the Tigers as well? I'm going to go with the Indians. In this one, they got Kluber, reigning Cy Young.
That's what I just said. Okay.
No, you said White Sox. Yeah. You didn't say
Indians. I think
Indians.
The Indians are second place. Yeah.
Terry Francona, looking good. I like him as a coach. I think the Indians actually is this year to pull through in the Central. All right, going to the West here, AL West right over here. Oakland A's, Angels, Seattle Mariners, Texas Rangers, and Houston Astros. Everybody 1-1 so far to start the season. Renee, who you got?
I'm going to have to take the Seattle Mariners in the American League West.
They made a lot of moves in the offseason,
They made
man.
Some moves in the offseason, and they can be a pretty dangerous
that
team,
Seth
I think.
Smith, they finally got some protection over there for
good. He was good for the Cano. Padres. Yeah.
Did
by
well.
By so. Far the best division in baseball.
I mean,
by
got Iwakuma. They got Felix over there.
The Angels have the pitching. They have a couple good pitchers, but Chris Wilson, I mean.
If Richards doesn't come back. Like he was last year, you can't count on Weaver and CJ day in and day out to get it done for you. CJ looked good.
I think CJ looked great.
He did, but I mean, we've seen him look great before. I want to see a full season as CJ.
No, I think the Angels win this division. Best division in baseball. The wild card will come from this division.
Yeah, I know. We'll record it. Yeah, we're going to get back on this. What do you got, John?
I got to go with Seattle.
Going with Seattle on this one? This is tough here.
It's Seattle, people. You realize this, right?
I think Oakland, despite having a good pitching staff with Sonny Gray and even having it in that ballpark, they seem to get it done year in and year out. But I think they lost too much, losing Cespedes, losing a little bit on offense. Seth Smith again. They lost Donaldson as well.
Yep.
Lost a lot on offense. I don't think they have
best bullpen, but not enough.
Yeah, not enough offensively. I'm going to go with the Angels on this one in a shootout against the Mariners. Yeah, I think it's going to come down one of those Mariners-Angels seasons again. But like you said, it all counts on Richards coming back. And does Shoemaker have the same year he had last year?
Oh, Shoemaker's going to be the shit.
They got to start scoring some runs. I mean, this offense has got to get – I mean, it's only been for, two, three games
They'll
now.
Be all right. I think a lot depends, really, and this is going to sound really odd, but a lot depends on C.J. Cron.
Yeah.
They're putting lot on his shoulders as a second-year guy to make some stuff happen, and I'm not really sold on him. But, I mean, if he has a decent year, 285, 290,
about
95
jacks,
RBIs,
18 jacks
then they win. Yeah.
I agree with you on that one. And it's going to be see what Josh Hamilton does. That's going to be a big issue for the Angels as well.
That's going to be really –
I mean, they're paying the guy $25
That's
going to
be really
dollars.
Odd. If he,
I think the Angels should just move on.
I mean, how can you not – I mean, Hamilton and then the Vernon Wells contract, four years before that, they've just blown money away right now, the Angels have. So, hopefully it doesn't come back to bite him in the butt. Yeah, switching to the National League here. The Braves, surprisingly 3-0. I mean, they let go of so many people. And they're at the top right now. Again, it's early in the season. The Nationals are just, their starting pitching staff is just sick.
It is.
I mean, unbelievable. Starting with Gio, Scherzer, Zimmerman. They've got just a stacked lineup over there. The Mets, they've already had their injury, but they're starting Bartolo effing Colon.
Yeah,
I know he did. He won the first game.
I call him Butthole Colon.
Is that not sound
the
bad?
Philadelphia Phillies, where they got the most expensive beer in the MLB. And Miami Marlins, it's already starting. They're 0-3, and it's already, they spend all that money on Giovanni Stanton. And it's early. Fernandez still has to come back, but I got Nationals. I think this is a given here. Nationals take right, Renee? Nationals take it?
Yeah, you know what? I was kind of rooting for the Marlins because they picked up a lot of good people and they've been shitty for a long time.
Yeah.
And I thought they were going to be good and they started off 0-3, but
it's early.
I'm going to have to go for the Nationals.
Yeah, Nationals.
I'm going Natty's also.
John?
I got to go for my heart, and it's the Braves.
Oh, you're a Braves fan?
Wow.
My son loves the Braves, too.
Okay, go with the Braves.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Yeah, well.
I don't know, man. For some reason, they get it done happen. Every I mean, yeah. They've been
not
there.
This year.
Hey, they got no. They do.
Not
it's going to be hard this year. All right, in the Central. Everybody's World Series favorites here, the Chicago Cubs. Cincinnati Reds, St. Louis Cardinals, Pittsburgh Pirates, Milwaukee Brewers here. This is kind of the division that's always kind of a shootout. You never really know. Yes. I mean, the Cardinals usually control.
Absolutely.
Cardinals usually the top dogs, but Pirates have been here of late.
Everybody's same closing thing the gap, with, that's for sure.
Reds have had their run here, there. Brewers back in the day with CeCe when he was there. But I'm going to go with – I think the Cubs actually do it, man. I love their coach, and I'm going to go all on the coach here.
All right.
I think they do it. I think the Cardinals remind me of the Spurs. It's like everyone always counts them out of here, but they do it every single year despite, you know, who's on their team. I'm going to go with the Cubs. I'm going to go with the trendy pick just because that's what I do. What do you got, Renee?
I hate the Cardinals.
All right. Yeah. Why? Because he about as much as Kershaw every year because Kershaw about can't get by
They're like second to the Giants. Yeah, they're second. And then it's the Yankees third. But I say
the Yankees are in everybody's top three, I'm sure.
This is the Central?
Yeah.
Ooh. Come on, Renee.
Cardinals, Cubs, Pirates.
Pirates. I'm going Pittsburgh.
You going Pittsburgh
yeah,
in
going
this
Pittsburgh.
One? Wow. McCutcheon, good job. McCutcheon cut his hair, man.
Without his locks, done.
I'm going Pittsburgh.
All right, what do you got, Knock?
Freaking Messi just scored a fucking great ass
goal.
Yeah,
we posted
right
that earlier.
Damn,
yeah,
that hooked
foot,
in.
Yeah,
left
that left
foot hooker?
Yeah.
Damn.
He's insane.
I don't know. It looked kind of messy to me.
Renee, wow. That was way.
Are you
no.
serious? Just run
it's
the board,
a,
okay?
Eat some chocolate.
Just run the board.
Yeah,
my
what do you
God.
Got? What do you got in the Central here?
Well, I'm one of those, man. Until you beat the champion, they're the champion.
Go Cards again?
I'm going Cardinals.
John?
Yeah. Got to.
I'm going to go with you with the Cubs.
You know what the Cubs
yeah,
is?
I got it in my heart. They deserve it.
I know. I'm all in on the Cubs. I know.
Definitely.
I'm all in,
definitely.
Though. I'm all
gonna
in on the Cubs.
Break your heart again.
All right. Coming out west here, NL West. This is, again, another good division. Giants, Padres making incredible moves in the offseason
yes.
here.
Yes.
Dodgers, Diamondbacks, and Rockies. Rockies look good out the gate, but again, it's early. I'm gonna go with the Doyers in this one too. I like the moves they did in the offseason. I don't mind getting rid of Matt Kemp. Yeah, he's done good the first couple days, but watch.
I think every
give him
45
games and have his knees act up, and he'll be on the DL
he's
before
going DL
you know
DL
it.
Within 60 games.
I don't have to say anything. You just spoke for me.
All right, there we go. Renee, what do you got?
Doyers.
John.
Doyers.
Giants. Oh, you want to kick his ass right now?
Cut his mic off.
Cut
him off.
No more shots for him.
Cristiano, like your dad anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
No more shots.
Exactly.
I'm not wasting my maker's mark on that asshole.
Oh, man.
Give him the cock. Give him the cock.
Give him the cock.
Oh, this definitely wasn't cock.
Make him walk the cock. Walk the cock.
From Owens.
From Owens. Get the double-sided cock out. All right, guys. Last little bit here before I close up. We got 1 minute here.
Double side.
Spanning the globe to bring you the constant variety of sports.
That's right. Wild World of Sports here, guys. We bring it to you all again. Let's just talk a little bit the Masters. Coming up this weekend, it's one of the best events, golfing events of the year. Mm-hmm. It's Augusta. It's a dream come true to play there.
Hey, if you want to bet on the Masters, you can go to SportsTradeX, right?
SportsTradeX.com.
SportsTradeX.com, official DFS of the Sportscast.
New promo code GURU. We'll hook you up with a special
right.
deposit
get
there.
Get your special deal
Guru,
there.
Again.
And you can bet on the Masters and anything else that you want to bet
They're
on.
They're going to have NASCAR coming up this weekend. They got daily baseball fantasy leagues. They've got daily basketball, hockey, golf, everything you can think of.
Win your money,
check
man.
Check out for
Test
the
yourself.
Newsletters. I'll be emailing them out later this week. SportsTradeX.com. They're going to have their own segment coming up in the next few weeks. Here, I just talked to Ben today.
Yeah, what you got, man? What you
make
got?
Make sure you guys
bring
check
it.
Out SportsTradeX.com, guys, the official daily fantasy site of the Sportscast. So,
absolutely.
A real quick knocker. Tiger,
yes.
He's back, looks in good spirits. What do you expect from this weekend?
I expect him to compete. Like I said at the beginning of the show, he would not put his ass out there to be embarrassed again. He's been embarrassed.
You don't think he pulls a, oh, I'm hurt because he's losing by a few strokes again,
no.
You know?
He's relaxed. He's enjoying it.
No,
I don't think he can pull a Jim Kelly card again.
I think he can
yeah,
do it.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I think he's out there, and I think he feels really good, and I think the 3 weeks off was fantastic for him.
Okay.
He's got his kids out there.
Think he contends.
Absolutely.
I think he's there on Sunday?
I think on Sunday he's within five strokes.
Okay.
And if he's within five strokes...
Yeah.
Within five strokes, he can win the damn tournament.
Okay.
So I think Spieth has a really good chance.
I'm rooting for Spieth this week, and that's why I talked with John earlier. Mm-hmm, I like the backstory, you know, with this kid.
I like J.P. Holmes, who won the last tournament last week.
What about Rory, man? Rory's coming into this thing.
Well,
if he wins this, what's his third in a row?
Yeah.
You know, he's got a lot
of
pressure.
Well, no, he's never won the Masters, so no, it'll be the third major. Yeah,
yes,
but he's going for the career Grand Slam.
Right.
So, he's always a threat.
He could be the Cinderella story, too.
He could be.
Yeah.
And Bubba, too. Can't count Bubba out.
Yeah, can't count Bubba out either.
But I think, to your question, yeah, I think Tiger's going to compete, and he will be within five strokes on the last.
Lastly, day. Before we that?
He's matured.
Yeah, yes. He has matured. Lastly, before we go on Wobble to Sports, just real quick, a couple side notes because we have soccer fans out there. Cristiano Ronaldo scored 5 goals earlier this week against Granada in their 9-1 victory. He had a hat trick by halftime in that.
Goals in a soccer game?
It was 9-1. He scored 5 of them. He had a hat trick by halftime.
But 9 goals were scored in a soccer game.
Yeah, knocker. Insane. Can you believe that, dude?
No effing way.
Yeah, that's not a joke.
Wow. Okay.
I know, and you are your son. And now, guys, coming up, if you want to check out on the website real quick. A couple stories in our trending video section, guys. As we all know, Super Troopers, one of the favorite movies out there.
I love
Farva! Yeah, Farva. They're coming out with Super Troopers 2.
Hey, man, check it out, man. Our boy Chris Mars. It's on the TV there. That's cool.
Check it out, though. Super Troopers. You can check it out. They went to actually police boot camp. You can believe that.
I love that.
Yeah, so
I
check out that video.
That's the most awesome thing ever.
Oh, you
got to
go to Donuts?
Yeah, you got to. Exactly. Next up here, guys, if you want the fails of the week, we got Babes in Bikini Boat Fails, guys. Don't miss that
video.
Those
are awesome.
We also got physics experiment gone painfully wrong when a guy gets smashed in the nuts with an axe.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh.
This physics teacher puts a board on this guy's stomach, trying to, he misses him, hits him right in the nuts. Oh. You can check out the video on our website. There's blood. There's blood.
Yeah. Ow. We got a bleeder.
Next up here.
Got a bleeder.
Spring break bro jumps off a hotel 3 stories into a pool.
I saw that.
Dude, it's nuts.
What the fuck are you thinking about?
Jesus Christ. Really?
Yeah,
my God. Geez.
Where?
Crazy. Jesus Christ.
Are you serious? Oh, my goodness.
Lastly, we saw March Madness as it just passed. March Madness, we got the best basketball fails up there as well, guys. You want to see guys trying to pull trick shots off that don't work, hit themselves in the face, end up going over.
Always good.
Or chicks is the best. These chicks that try, hey, guys, watch
me. Let me try.
I'm going to try and step on this, foldable chair and watch me eat face first into the ground. So check out all those videos today. At thenewsportscrew.com and sportscastlife.com.
On the website the other side of March Madness, right? The sadness.
March Sadness. You can check out that. Anne Hathaway performing Miley Cyrus's Wrecking
Ball.
She
was awesome.
Oh, that was awesome.
Did you see that?
I saw the clip.
On the Limpsic battle. Yeah, that was pretty good.
Awesome. I'm going to watch. I don't watch much TV. Yeah. But I like
the Rock
whole
doing
premise.
Shake It Off the other night. Like, that was
I
fantastic.
I like the premise of the lip sync battle. Yeah, I like that.
It was good. So, all right, guys. Well, we want to thank you once again for checking in here on the Sportscast again every Wednesday, 6:30 to 8:30. Make sure you guys check us out on iTunes. Spread the word. Tell a friend. Sign up for the golf tournament, guys. You only got 2 weeks left, May 2nd.
Yeah.
Get your registrations in. 1, 2, we'll take foursomes. It doesn't matter. We'll take it all. If you guys want to sponsor a tee.
There's a drop.
There you go. If you guys want to sponsor a tee, it's only $75, guys.
Yeah,
it helps us out.
Sponsor a hole, man.
Get your business name out there as well.
For sure.
For Renee on the ones and twos, Johnny Icebox for always make this thing work. And for our special guest today, Steve John. Well, thank you guys for checking
John,
in today.
Thank you.
Bringing the shots. Bud Knocker.
Thank you to Caitlin.
Yeah, thank you, Caitlin, once again, all the callers. You guys make this all possible every week. We enjoy what we do. And we'll be back next week, same time, same place. Love you all.
See ya.